Okay, I think we're good. Everything should be working. Sorry about the late start, everybody. We had to help one of the newbies in our squad today get set up with mods. So yeah, had to take care of that a little bit. And Kieran shared some not safe for stream stories about work. So yeah, it took a little bit of an extra minute to get going. But anyway, hey, what it do, fellow gamers? It's me, your boy, the Death Topping, back at it for another week of Spawn Streams in the Mines tonight with Deep Rock Galactic. This one's going to be, we're going to take a little bit of a break next week, as apparently the spawns are going to get a bit of an overhaul over the weekend to prepare for the, I don't know if it's just a new thing that Goldblade's doing or if it's to get ready for the next season, which is also coming out soon. They released more details about that earlier today, which I am very excited for. Not safe for stream. It's a mature stream. Well, it's less not safe for stream, more it has like personal information that Kieran doesn't want to have shared. So, but yes, we got a full lobby tonight right off the bat. We got Zach, Kieran, and Zach's brother Ben joining us for the first time in a while. I think it's been a good couple years since Ben has joined up for a Deep Rock spawn stream. He plays with us normally I think he's done Risk of Rain with us once or twice, but he mainly does like Vermintide with us and everything. So yeah, we'll be having him. So I believe that means, because I don't know if he's promoted any of his dwarves yet, that will mean there probably won't be a deep dive tonight unless we can really crank through his promotion assignment and get that done. So yeah, we're gonna take a bit of a break next week because this will be the last proper week of spawn streams, at least for that week. I'm hoping to get them all back up by the end of next week and set up for the 31st, which lands on a Wednesday, so we can get our Gunner Nom Drunk Rock going. So yeah, that's pretty much all like the big announcements that we have for today. So let's get right into it. I believe Kieran's explained to Ben how our icebreaker questions are going to be working tonight, so this should be very entertaining. Let's do it.
This towards everybody. Just imagine you're in a class, right?
Oh, this is what I come back to? Oh, dear. We're in class? Yes, Professor Kieran.
My work did something, and I'm trying to dumb it down because there's a lot of financial...
Is this basically someone screws up the bell curve for everyone kind of thing?
No. Kind of. So, this one like... first. Imagine during one semester, your teacher decides, hey, you know what, I'm going to change how I structure the grade. So I'm going to take a moment to do that, and during that time, you guys don't have to worry about grades. And you're like, oh, shit, okay, we don't have to worry about grades all that much.
That's
you
nice.
You still do your work, you still do pretty great, and you actually end up with a lot of A's on everything. But the teacher decides that since they didn't they didn't have a defined grading scale, like what they were measuring for, during that period of time, they instead are going to, by default, just to make it easy on themselves, give everyone a D, just so that they are all on the same level.
That's nice, but okay. To the fallen. All right, bruise up for those who wish to grab it. We got pots of gold from chat. Thank you, chat.
Meaning we all basically got the minimum payout, and a lot of us are pissed because a lot of us put in some hard work and actually got some nice A's. But they're all like, no, you got a D.
Nice. That's wee-haw.
Hey, hate to see it.
Yep. Oh, boy. All right, peeps are rolling in. Heard there might be a Civ 5 stream. Yes, Fern, there will be next week as our break, which I am very excited for.
A survive stream? I mean, Civ 5.
A survival stream. We are thrown out in the middle of the woods for 24 hours and are told to survive.
We'll be fine.
Yeah, I'm very hyped for that one in particular, because it's been a minute since I've played, but I've also been really wanting to play Civ 5 recently. So it's gonna be pretty good. Cheers, Mike. All right, well, I don't know about you lads, but I am ready to go for this mission. Rock and
stone, you beautiful. Oh, of course, you're ready.
Come on, all you right. Easy bastards. We've got a job to do.
Are you getting your fit assembled, Kieran? All right.
Quite possibly.
Shit!
Oh, what'd you do?
I fell down the pit. It's okay, I'm picking up the ball. The ball's coming with
us. You're fired.
Can I toss it up? Yeah! All right, it's been a minute since you've done a spawn stream with us, Ben, so I just... I hope you're ready.
Yep.
You are not prepared.
It'll be fine. It'll be fine.
It'll be fine. It'll be fine. Just kill bugs. There's going to be a lot of them, and we may or may not get overwhelmed. If we can focus our fire, we should be okay.
Yeah, we will still die.
We will probably die, without a doubt.
All right.
Okay. We're all set.
Yep.
Kieran, what you got going? Ooh. I'm liking it. I'm liking it. All right. I don't know about you guys where you guys are at, but fucking A, it's hot as balls over here.
I despise it.
Yeah, I hate it. We should be getting a bit of a cooler next few days and the next coming week, but still, it's going to come right back up.
How are things down in Arizona, Ben?
Air conditioned.
Mike, fuck you. You have air conditioning.
Listen.
I hate you so much right now. I know I barely know you, but I hate you.
Listen. It would not be livable without air conditioning.
It would not. Absolutely.
Open the door, and it's like opening an oven.
Every single city down there, and I don't care if every other city is different in terms of its temperature, every city in Arizona is a monument to man's arrogance.
It's literally fucking, like, just
buildings and then flat fucking desert and then suddenly cliffs.
Then suddenly cliffs.
Don't forget the house mountains.
It's just flat as hell and then massive mountain.
The good old Superstition Mountain.
Superstition Mountain.
Mildly
Depressed says air conditioning is the only reason Vegas is livable. We can bake cookies or fry eggs with the sun.
Yes.
Oh, God.
Also, the bugs there.
Yep. Oh, God. Went to Vegas once. I don't think I'll ever be going back. Maybe in the winter when it's somewhat cooler. We'll see. Oh, who hasn't loaded? Oh! Okay, I guess we're good.
I thought that was a new cool loading screen, like we're about to enter an alien or something, and the door slowly open.
Someday, Kieran, someday. All right, let's do this, gents. Woo! Cargo crate, right off the bat.
Oh, sweet. All right, Ben, do you remember how to do things?
Vaguely.
Sea bug. Kill bug, mine minerals, bring back to big fuck off facility, win.
Yeah, that's right, Ben. There's some new shit.
Oh, you turn the volume down. Oh, God.
Was the last time that we streamed this in like 2020 the last time you played this, Ben?
Perhaps.
Oh, no. There have been some new features.
Okay, so this one's fun, Ben. We get to build pipes.
I forget. Oh, yeah, I remember this one.
Okay, cool.
Hold on. What's the pickaxe button?
The fun thing, it's hold your right click. Oh, okay. God. All right, we're already fucked up. This will be perfect.
We're already fucking.
And the nice thing, Ben, about one of the mods that I have is, do you remember if there was a limit before to the pipelines that we would place? Like specifically to the length?
I don't.
Well, there was, and there no longer is. So you can make long as fuck pipelines if you wish.
Hold on. I'm having a lot of difficulty talking and playing right now.
You're good. Want to redeem Lootzilla. Where's Lootzilla? Where's Lootzilla? I don't see it. I think it might have died. Hold on, Ben.
What?
Come here.
What should we do?
The new Festerflea spawn that I have spawns grenades whenever you're close to them, so be mindful of those little fuckers right there.
He called them kamikaze.
Ooh!
Like that!
They can freeze, they can inflame.
Okay, so they do everything.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
What the fuck is this?
What, cave leech?
Look at its placement.
It's just Flyers. Sitting there. Oh, that's I think that's natural. Oh, Jesus Christ! Guanju's pissed he can't join us tonight. He's exacting vengeance.
Guanju's like, I want to answer ice drinkers.
Get him! Get it!
Let me kill that thing.
Kill the things on the side.
Ooh! What the fuck is going on? Okay, I'm getting peeps back up. There you go, get it repaired. Where's Kieran? Where's Kieran? I don't see him, he's right next to us.
I repaired it.
Did you use your iron will to repair the Betsy, Kieran?
It was not the smartest choice, I grant you, but it was the only choice.
It was a choice. That much can be said. Okay, well, it looks like we got all the pump jacks up, so let's get those pipelines from the refinery connected. What is going on?
Better rev up those fires.
Zach?
Yeah?
What happened there?
What do you think happened?
Did a fester flea get you, or did you fall to your death? Oh, Jesus!
Yeah. I mean, isn't he playing what? Scout?
Yes.
That's my boy.
Well, it's a good thing I have field medic on this build. I'm playing my medic engineer, because I think we're going to need it.
What would make you say that? What are you trying to say, Jonah?
Just a hunch, you know.
Do you not trust us in our build?
I trust you guys. I don't trust chat.
You hear that, Ben? He doesn't trust us.
He doesn't trust us.
All right, okay. Okay, that fuck different.
Chad, do you think Jonah should trust us? Leave a comment indicating your choice.
Why am I being gaslit now, guys? Chill out. I trust you guys, please.
He doesn't trust us. We must consider this an act of treason.
Hold up. I trust you guys. Okay, what does chat have to say? Hello, Eden. Welcome to chat. And Fern says, my life has been consumed by Final Fantasy. Oh, boy.
Hell yeah.
That is not a affirmation of trust.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, hello, Dreadnought. Probably should put down my turrets.
Oh, my God.
That'd be smart. Here, let's fight it down here, Kieran. You ready? Ooh!
I'm sorry, I'm busy creating an abomination of a pipeline.
Alright, as long as you're building them, who cares? It's fine.
Are you sure about that?
I trust you.
You know how I build pipelines, Jonah.
I trust you to build a pipeline. Whether or not it's, Oh, hey, Ben.
Hey, it there did go. A thing. I'm gonna do it again.
Yeah, just get back. Get away from it when it does that. Yeah, but shoot it in the ass.
It did it on the other side of the pipe, so, like, I couldn't quite see it doing that.
Oh, you're good, man. You're good. Alright, I got Shredder Squad going in. Get away, Kieran, get away!
Oh, no. Jump towards it.
What the fuck?
Fear not, Zach. I am saving you. And bravely leave our comrades behind to die.
Oh, don't wait on that rescue. Here comes the res.
Alright, you got him, Kieran.
Of course I got him. He's my boy. All right, and I'll also, I don't know if I can still trust you yet. I'm still waiting on chat.
Fern says, I trust everyone on screen. Fruitsushi says, I say this with love and respect, Kieran, but absolutely not. God damn. Get your ass up, Ben. No time to slack.
You hear, or that's accurate, so she says we shouldn't trust him. I knew he didn't trust us, but it's okay.
I guess it's fair, I did enable these spawns after all. But it's okay, we're gonna get a weak break from this shit.
Alright, Zach, remember, no Russian.
Karen!
Ooh, impact, oh fuck. We got a meteor coming in. We got a little mini event to do at some point. I charged your shield, so you should get more shield recharge. Oh, come on, Fruit Sushi, no!
Right now? You bastard!
Alright, Chad.
See, if I just get close enough, I don't have to worry about aiming.
Alright, we got a parasite infestation. You got the flamethrower, right, Ben?
Yeah.
Alright, there's gonna be a bunch of little dudes coming from the ceiling.
I'm trying. I can't even see.
Do your best. It's okay. We're in the... Ow! Kieran! I'm not a bug!
That's exactly what a bug would say.
I have been grabbed! Oh, God! Oh! No! 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 Bad, Kieran! Bad! I will spray you! Get up! Get up!
I get
Fuck!
It.
I was in the shield! Well, I'm down now. Are you happy, Kieran? Oh, Jesus, Zach! It's okay. I witnessed that happen.
I'm alive!
Oh, no! I hate the fact that rollers can go through the fucking shields. Almost for a thing. I have finished the first part of the second expansion. I haven't done the epilogue stuff of Final Fantasy. I've shown Zach a bit of the Manderville quest. Ben knows what I'm talking about. Okay. Wait a minute. That's not the right timer. Hold on. I'm going to disable that once we get out of here. That's for the last game we played. We are not playing Tears of the Kingdom. Oh! Oh, no. No, 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 no. All right. Well. Well, thanks, Kieran. All right, Ben. No pressure. But.
Shut up.
Oh, okay. No, look. My buddy Zach, don't worry. I'll save you.
This
whatever.
Motherfucker. There we go. All right, I have fixed the timers. We're not playing Tears of the Kingdom, Skellybot. It's going to be okay. Matter of fact, there we go.
I have no flavor ammo.
There we go.
Thanks, bud.
All right.
You saved me.
All right, guys. Guys, thank you, whoever saved me.
It's still here.
Ooh! See, this is why I brought Field Medic. Spoiler for Deep Rock, there are rocks in the deep. No! Someone banned her. Okay, we got mine set up. It's okay. Bring the dreadnought over to the wall. Come here. Come here. Come on. There you go. There you go. See? Look at it. It's doing work. It's doing work.
Are you fucking kidding me?
No problems. Now, about those pipelines. Let's get those set up.
We can get a... Fucking.
Remember when we had a mission to do, you guys?
I've been on my mission.
I think Ben needs ammo.
I need ammo too. So let's find some nitra while we build some pipes. Zach, if you can find some and mark them, I can platform them for you because we're in a pretty.
I would love to.
I see. Okay.
I would love to do that. There's a slight issue of me having no blood in my body.
Thank you, JT. Kieran, can we get a zip line up to Zach? Do you have any zip lines left? Zach, Kieran, that's not. Okay, here, I'll help you out. Kieran's opting for the.
How are you managing to expertly play into the stereotype the scouts is?
There you go, Kieran. Do you have? Is that good? Is that platform good there for you?
Do you like my pipeline, Ben?
Okay, cool. That works.
It confuses me.
welcome to my
you
world.
You should see what Guanji has done. Jonah has to wrestle certain things away from us because we will make the most convoluted fucking thing.
Like it's funny at first, and if there's nothing else going on in the cave, it's fine. But like when there are bugs literally everywhere and we are fighting for our life,
it's so funny.
Kieran, yes. You can just revive me. Kieran.
The question is, will Kieran leave you?
Kieran!
Ah, I see he switched his target now. There we go. Alright, let's they're up there, Ben, so let's do our part down here. Get through all this
Kieran,
fucking bullshit.
Kieran.
At least you have turrets.
You can just revive me and I can get my own way down. You're going to fall and die.
It'll be funny. Is he trying to mine you out or something?
Yes! Oh, look at that! I fell to the fucking bottom of the cave, you fucking idiot!
Task failed successfully.
Hey, dummy.
I saved you the trouble of doing it yourself.
Alright, battery.
Yeah,
I have both batteries.
Cargo crates right over here.
Yeah. All right. Cool.
Okay, what is this one connected even? What is happening with this one? Oh, I see what's.
It's
I
the one thing. Zach made.
I see what's going on here. Okay, I like it. I like this.
I don't.
I'm not mad at this. This is fun. Okay. Fruit Sushi says, okay, I got pizza bun with bacon at Uwaji's, and they were not kidding. It is, in fact, pizza in a bun with bacon. Well, I mean, that's pretty good advertising in that case. Let me get some of that.
Cheers, I'll drink to that.
What happened?
One
of the fleas?
I want you to guess.
The one of the fleas get you, Ben.
What do you think happened, Jonah?
I don't know. I wasn't there.
What do you think happened to our poor Ben? The poor boy.
At some point.
Look at that face.
You have to assume that if someone spontaneously explodes for no reason at all, you can assume the reason. Well, you would think one would figure out.
Given how the spawns work sometimes I do need an explanation.
It's okay, John. I understand.
Kieran, do you understand my plight?
It's hard to use brain power, I know.
Yes, it is, especially in this heat. Barrels!
Don't get your loot!
Alright, loot crates
like
up.
An excuse. Alright, what kind of pizza am I feeling tonight?
That's a great question, Kieran. I'm going to take a wild swing in the dark for you. Cheese.
Well, the flavor, yes. What brand?
What brand? My brand. Wait, who's carrying? Is it you? Let's bring it to that one. No, go for it. Go for it.
No. I thought I was building.
Oh, you're all good. All right, pipe set.
But you could have made that so much more complicated.
Yes, I could have. But I would like to do other things. I would like to do other missions tonight, Zach.
You see, that I don't understand. Can you explain that to me as though I was a child?
Big pipe. Oh, God!
Big pipe, oh, God. See, I still don't understand. What's he on about, chat?
Big pipe, long and messy. Need small pipe to make mission go faster.
So that's the full sentence.
Yes, that's the full sentence.
Big pipe.
Oh, God!
Big pipe. Oh, no! Fern says, I'm laying right in the way of the fan. That is how I'm surviving. And Fern says, hey, Kieran, can I have pizza too? Oh, geez. Okay, I got mines here. This will help.
It's about to go.
Run!
Ooh!
Unfortunately, the cure needs to be provisional this particular week.
Oh, I heard that. Come here, Crassus. Come here.
For those who did not hear, my bonus is not coming in the way I was expecting it was.
No bonus? Wait, hold on. No bonus?
Okay, is anyone down there next to that other detonator?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
I am right here. I'm right here. Kieran, oh dear.
I landed on it. It's now disoriented.
Okay, well,
you guys have ammo?
My bonus was supposed to be, five times what I'm actually getting.
Oh my God. Oh!
I'm getting one fifth of my anticipated bonus, and I am upset. So I'm getting pizza for myself to make me happy.
And a Philip, apparently.
Ben.
Thanks,
I got you, Ben.
I do not regret that choice.
Oh God, it's going up!
Alright.
Hey, we did it!
It didn't give us any gold, though, which is funny. It blew up on the thing.
Lots of gold over here.
Oh, I've been swept. Ooh.
Oh, God. There's a lot of Praetorians right here.
Yeah, we got a pack of Praetorians.
I believe they are pronounced Praetorians.
Praetorians.
I believe it's pronounced fuck off.
I believe it's pronounced, why is there Philip here? Damn it, Kieran.
I believe it's pronounced Typhlin.
Oh no.
Listen here, you fucking piece of shit.
You wanna fucking go, goddammit? I'll take you down, son!
Kieran, we're not starting a fight, okay? Okay, here's what I'm gonna do for this one. We're gonna wrap this around.
Bringing around town.
Bringing around town. Okay. All right. No problems.
It's my archer rifle, Zach.
Oh, not this fucking PvP shit again! Stop!
What are you clowns doing?
King shooting me.
That started it.
Do you see what I do? Do you see what I deal with, Ben?
Yeah, you started it.
Oh!
What happened?
A fester flea spawned out of a loot bug's anus, and here I am.
I'm on my way. But there is a ghost.
You're all good. I'm in a pretty remote part of the cave. Why did I get down?
Don't worry. I'm taking express.
There's a ton of red sugar near me if you need more health. Oh boy. Princess, I see how it is, Kieran. You don't care about me at all.
this is true. When I get a fifth of my bonus, I don't care for anyone but myself.
You know what? Let you be selfish, Kieran. Oh no, oh Ben, I saw that. I'm so sorry.
I fucking hate that mod. I'm just letting you know right now.
Here's the thing, Ben. Because you played with that mod when we first had it, right? The exploding fester fleas. I programmed those myself.
I do show love randomly exploding.
I'm sorry, Zach, but I had no choice.
Okay, can we...
You had every choice.
Gentlemen, can we put aside our differences? And at the very least, for a moment, can you please get us up?
Well, you see, I actually was about to until you put yourself as the middleman, and now I have to kill him. Sorry. This will teach you to try to mend the bridge, Jonah, that's already been mended.
Emotional damage!
There you go. Never mind.
Yeah, there's a... Oh, God! Did they all spawn on me? Oh, that's
cool.
Yeah,
they did.
That's
God
cool.
God damn it, Zach!
What happened? It's okay. There's a ton of red sugar. Feel free to eat any of it and all of it. Thank you, Zach.
It's okay. There's no witnesses to attest my friends.
Oh, God, there we go. Thank God that one sugar baby loot bug died over here. All right, let's go get Kieran up. Oh, here, hold on. I have no ammo for it. This is going to be rough.
I'm just pointing it out so you can...
I'm going in. I'm going in.
Ghosty.
Now that PvP warm-up has been taken care of, I say we move on to the other kind of PvP.
I'm so mad. Oh, and Philip's humping my body. Thank you, Philip.
Oh, I won't raise you, but,
the supply pod right after I go down, Fern. Icing on the cake.
Yeah, if I draw Philip away...
Are you busting out the icebreakers, Kieran?
I got them already, yeah.
Okay. Whenever you want to.
I'm good. My food is ordered. It will sit according to the clock. It says it will be here in 8 minutes, though. So I'm going to wait until after I've cooked it, and then I am consuming it liberally.
Sounds good. All right.
But in the meantime, let me throw some mods at you guys since we have just a little bit more PvP.
Oh, motherfucker!
No! Someone get him up now!
I'm trying. He died in a weird spot.
Oh, is he on the pipe?
Yes.
I got him.
What a neat boy.
The pipes are crying. Okay, hold on. Oh, there he goes. All right, we're good.
Down I go again. Oh,
God, no! No! I did not take field medic just so you could sit there and, well, there you go.
Now I can sit here.
No, you will sit with me, Kieran.
Aw, man, my bubble.
It's okay, chat's got you covered. Don't even fucking worry about it. We have an imposter somewhere. Where is it?
Amogus.
Amogus. Ding, 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 ding.
Man, it's been ages. I actually kind of
want to play Amogus. Oh god, is it time for an Amogus reunion tour?
Not to be the back in my day kind of person, but I liked it when it was simpler before they added all the shit.
Man, I think all they needed to do with it was just add a few more maps, and that's it. Oh, like,
okay, boomer.
Fuck you.
It is kind of a boomer thing to say, Zach.
I'm aware of that, but I still maintain it that it was better before they started adding a bunch of weird shit.
It's like every Minecraft player talking about beta compared to these days. I remember when redstone was a new thing.
Okay, no, but I will make the argument. They are adding just random things to Minecraft.
That's very true.
I don't, like, they're adding random things that, like, okay, nothing has to have a use, but, like, at the same time, they're just adding things.
Well, aren't there, like, cherry blossom trees now?
Something like that.
Listen, again, the other thing is that it's like, they act, it's like, from how they post things or make content, it's like, you'd think it would be like them slaving away at a coal mine, and then there's a modder making an entire, like, other game.
An entire new dimension.
Unpaid. Without dev training or tools, like.
And you know what's funny? They hire those modders, like the one for the Moan Creatures mod, and then they don't do shit! Like, we got horses and camels and sniffers, but that's, like, what bees, technically, yes. Fern says, but bees, Ben. And yes, I would, like, love to hear a boomer moment, please.
When they add things, it's great, but it's like, you'd think it would be, like, tremendously hard to make anything for that game. Because of how fucking long it takes them.
True, yeah. And the fact that they've gone back on several things with that.
And then there's the horse thing. The horses used to look a lot better, and then they, like, changed them, and now they look weird.
They scrunkle the horses.
The animations don't even work. They, like, look like they're sliding half the time.
I can confirm this. As someone who's been playing a lot of Minecraft recently, the horses do look pretty weird.
Oh, it's no, I'm down again.
Nonsense.
Kieran, no, you're not. Zach, get him up. Thank you. All right, we got two of them connected. We just need three more Apocablooms if anybody has them.
You're an Apocabloom.
I'm about to turn into one.
Look at
Apocalypse! Oh! Oh God!
What happened? This thickening.
There was a crevice that appeared. I'm gonna patch this up. Give me a sec.
For the 17th time, it is pronounced crevasse.
Crevasse. My apologies.
Listen to here, you fucker.
There we go. Okay.
Fucking.
Fern said, just play Minecraft Story Mode. I actually played that. I played that with my siblings before I moved out, and it's an experience. It's an experience. I will say that much.
Story Mode for Minecraft?
It's a Telltale game.
But it's Minecraft.
But it's Minecraft, and it's about...
It's horrible.
It's about as good as you expect.
It is of, odd quality.
Like, on its own, as a Telltale game, it's not bad, but as a story, it's like...
I mean, another thing to consider is targeted age.
That's true.
Before we do the thing, we have a meteorite to deal with.
Yes, we do. Where is that? I did not actually see that land.
Like, other side of the cave.
Like,
are you sure about that?
There it is.
Fairly, because it's right there.
Oh, Kieran? God.
I fell 2 feet and I died!
Kieran, I'm gonna get you up.
That's not so funny when it happens to you, is it?
Let's get you to a supply pod.
Aw, damn, I fell on a barrel. That's what happened.
You got weak ankles.
Let's go up here.
Got weak ankles.
The fucking fall damage.
It's fucked.
Isn't
that
always one
barrels?
Of the fun things to test with a new game is, does this have fall damage?
And you just plummet off of a cliff.
Every time a game has, like, bullshit where it's not actual, like, fall damage, I just have that gif of that Family Guy episode where they hold up the rule book and say, I guess we won't be doing this anymore.
No! My creation!
Fuck your creation! I want to leave!
Where are you, morons?
We are over here.
We are here
in this meteorite. So
over here, that's... completely fixes everything.
I literally pinged myself, Garrett. No, don't you fucking start with me!
I will end your ping.
You, yes, with the way you're shooting me. Eden says, my boss is so bad at the computer. This is for her boomer moment, by the way. He will re-download the file every time he wants to open the file. He will minimize the file, then he re-downloads the file to reopen it.
Why?
No! Oh, God. Okay. Oh!
Okay, Ben, I need you to quickly look over here and see why Jonah takes things away from me.
Betsy! Every time. Every time, Ben, right here. This is why.
I am going to hurt you, brother.
I got it before it was too late. Okay, so we need to maintain these rock crackers. We need to repair them every now and then. But if you want to focus on just getting the bugs, that works too. That actually really helps. Oh, I should have set up my turrets. I'm an idiot. Give me a sec.
You fucking idiot.
Jesus. Fuck. Yeah. We need to repair one. One needs to be repaired.
I got it. Thank you. Turret's going up. We have infestered.
Infestered's going up! Oh, dear. Nope. I'm staying away from that. Nope. Staying away!
Oh, no. I'm down again.
Now would be a good time to check my Discord messages.
Why do things explode?
Somebody spawned infestered, which spawns a bunch of fester fleas. I'm getting you guys up. At Jonah's location.
I'm getting you guys up. Okay, we're good.
I hear them. I hear more.
Ben's gonna have fucking PTSD of fester fleas.
Dude, I have PTSD with fester fleas.
We should, like, space out a little bit, you know?
Just a little bit, you know?
Just so if one fester flea shows up, we're not all fucking dead.
You know, that's...
What do you mean I'm supposed to move out of the AoE zone?
That is a good point, Ben. Sushi says, is it really a deep rock stream if I don't murder you all with infestern at least once? Here, let me buy you a drink as an apology. Wait, no, not like this.
And I can look at the fucked up things.
Yep, here we go.
I can't currently do that.
Wait, become sober, you lush.
Fuck you.
What is happening?
I will not become sober.
It says, I am in training and it's excruciating. So how you been, Gamma? It's hot over here, Gamma. I don't know if it's hot over where you're at, but fuck.
I can't fucking see!
Well then, sober up and then wait till you can see!
What
are you doing? Aaron? I can't see!
I'm taking care of
you. Oh,
wait,
I can see again.
Okay, look at this fucked up squid. Right here. I've got it in my hands.
Are you holding the plague heart? All right. We get extra bonuses if we collect these little squid thingies. God, there's so many particle effects going on right there.
Oh, what?
Fun fact of this season's theme is that the planet is diseased.
Oh.
You're a squid.
It's only getting worse next season.
It's literally infesting the very rock of the planet.
I would like some more.
Don't you dare.
You're a kid now. Don't you're a squid now.
No.
You're a kid. You're a squid. You're a kid. You're a squid. You're a kid. You're a squid.
All right. I'm going to be right back with my food, and then we shall begin the icebreaker.
Sounds good. Why is Kieran down again?
You know why.
Oh, okay. Understandable. Have a nice day.
You know why he's dead.
All right. How much gold do we have? I actually need money now because I just spent my last, like, 100,000 credits on my driller promotion. So, collect all the money we can get. We also need one more Apoca Bloom.
Oh.
Alright, I'm gonna go look for one, and then, honestly, if we want to start it now...
That's probably a wise decision.
Do we have all the play cards? I threw two of them. Oh, here's
one. Yeah, we have two.
Whoop!
The absolute terror in the driller's voice at Fester Flea.
There we
like
go.
He knows.
Driller knows what's up. It's just become a thing in like the base game now that Fester Fleas are a thing to be feared. That's how much influence this mod has had. Oh god. I think I saw more Apoca Blooms in this other cave. I'm gonna go look. I see one. Okay, we're good. I'm grabbing it. Fern says, what do you mean I have to move out of the AoE zone, says every DPS main.
I played tank in 14, and it's just like watching someone repeatedly, knowingly, or perhaps just even completely ignorantly, like no brain activity, in a big red AoE marker.
That's just it, even in my experience in WoW running dungeons and shit, that's just true in any MMO. DPS do not think. They only strive to be at the top of the damage charts. There are no thoughts behind their little frickin' squirrel brain. I mean, shit, that's rude to even put squirrels like that.
Yeah, man, why y'all be doing squirrels like that?
It's just they see big number.
They see big number, it gives them big dopamine rush.
They have unga-bunga brain.
Plateau.
There's one class in that game that is the worst about this. They're a caster, and their attacks are very slow to cast, but they hit really hard. So basically, the idea is you just want to plant yourself somewhere and then never move. So if they stand in AoE, they know what they're doing. They just don't care.
They just don't give a shit, yeah.
They will happily take all that damage if they can get off another spell.
For instance, I play as a healer in FF14, so it is once in a blue moon when a DPS uses their brain. I knew several rogues back in the day. Ooh, there go the frames. Jesus Christ.
Kills red.
Master Skywalker, there's too many of them.
Hold on, Zach, I'm on my way. See if I can get it from a distance. From a distance. Betsy. Okay. I didn't die, so that, Betsy. I'm gonna kick your ass, Betsy, if you keep this shit up. All right, I gotta go help Zach out. I think Kieran's still AFK, so I was gonna leave him there for until he gets back. He'll be fine, he's got things down there. My turrets are nearby, I think. All right, how you doing up here, Zach? What's going on here?
I'm having Luka Morkai shot into my womb, so it's not great.
It's kind of hot. I fell in the same goddamn spot. When will I learn? Nope, that's not the right pipe. Okay, you got that one?
I got it.
Okay, thank you. Because I clearly don't.
What do you have?
I don't know anymore. My brain's slowly melting cell by cell.
Are you not allowed to stand on the pipe? Like,
So because the mod allows it to extend to however long you want it to be, the game doesn't recognize that because it still thinks, oh, it can only be at like 8 or 9 meters. So anything above that, I don't know why. I think the modder has tried to fix that. You can still grind on them, but you have to stay on them like, the entire time.
Probably a physics thing.
Probably.
Yeah, okay.
Like, it only has so many physics objects.
Get off of
the pipes above a certain length don't get physics objects attached to them.
Boost his shields. Okay, just as a note, I did use my insta revive earlier, so. Said, I've had stupid tanks though, like the one that ran to a boss fight before I was done with a cutscene. You know when someone's in a cutscene too, so it wasn't like they couldn't know. Yeah, tanks have been pretty dumb too.
Tank occasionally has unga bunga brain.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
I've definitely had my moments playing as tank in WoW where I've had unga bunga brain. You got to make sure everybody's on the same page before going into a fight. I don't know if it's different in Final Fantasy 14, but...
Oh, yeah, no, you want to make sure everyone knows what's going on, because otherwise you're just going to have DPSs that will keep just dying, especially in, like, the later fights in the game, where they get, like, fast.
Yeah.
Where if you're not, like, on your toes and you don't have at least a rough idea of what's going to happen, you're just going to get slapped dead. As a tank, you can. There's a lot more forgiveness because you know you have a lot of health and like mitigation and healing. So you can afford to like fuck up a lot.
Yeah.
not as a DPS. Mm-hmm. You can afford to fuck up maybe once or twice, or like three times.
That sounds about right. Okay, Kieran's still okay. Got shot off the pipe. That was fun.
That was cool.
What happened?
The pipe launched me.
Yeah, I got launched too. Oh, same spot too. Hi, Ben.
Hi.
Here, I'll put a platform right here so we have a nice cushioned landing.
I would like that.
You blocked me in.
You're fine. You went above it. You weren't that deep.
No. You buried me.
Oh, I thought you got out. I'm sorry. No. Here you go. Here you go. Come on out.
You literally entombed me.
I'm sorry. How many times have you motherfuckers entombed me in the past?
That's not what we're talking about right now.
What the fuck? I'm Betsy. I'm going to delete you. Stop this. Oh my god. All right, let me get turrets up in this sector. I'll get Shredder Squad to help cover Kieran. Okay. I'll get this. I'll get Pipeline 2 that goes off into the other cave. Poink! Alright, we're good. Fern said I had a tank just focus on the boss, not bothering to try to keep pulling the boss's spawns. I was running around trying to not die. You gotta get the ads. The ads, man. They'll get you. Oh, ceiling dwarf munchers. Watch the ceiling. Ooh! They were sitting on the very edge of it. Ooh. Yeah, watch the skies, guys. There's cave leeches about. All right, need some help up here.
Where about that one?
All right, we're good. Hello, Kieran. Welcome back. Okay. The platform does kind of help. I'm gonna put it right here. I don't know if launching into the wall will make it worse or any better. Okay. All right, I'm sending it up. Does anybody have any minerals to deposit that they want before we go?
Just go. We can dump it into the supply pod.
All right, we're going.
Escape pod. Pod. We're going. Pod.
Pod. Into the pod. 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 The pod people.
Who told you about the pod people?
I know things, Zach. I have my tinfoil hat on. Says, I will say, even when people do stupid shit, I have literally only encountered a toxic party once in my entire time playing Final Fantasy 14. Yeah, that's kind of the vibe that I've gotten from that community in particular. It's very chill.
I've only run into an asshole like once.
Yeah.
And no one else in the party liked them, so it wasn't like a...
Like, oh, he's my friend. Ooh, yeah.
No. Like, everyone told them to shut up.
Where's the drop? Oh, it's in. So take pipeline 2. Take this one.
Imagine having to take a pipeline.
Imagine taking a shit ton of fall damage. Yeah, I got nothing for that one, do you, fucker?
Shut up! You stupid!
Nothing but love, man. Nothing but love.
Thank you.
Alright, I'll get some turrets set up out here to help cover. Shredder Squad, go! Take Pipeline 2, Kieran! Rock and roll. What's Kieran doing? Is he mining gold? Oh, okay, get in the pod, I'm gonna go check on him. Has he succumbed to the dragon sickness yet again?
It took him.
I made a grave mistake. There are several folks. Kieran, it's gonna be spicy, so jump off here. Jump off here and follow me. Go! Just get in the pod. Oh god! Oh, it's going up. Hey. Nice. We still got a couple more, like one or two more, I think. Kieran. Kieran. Oh no. I got him. I got him. Oh dear God. Follow me, soldier. Let's go.
I can't stun them anymore. I'm out of boomerangs.
Oh, that one's gonna go up. Oh God.
Get in the pod, get in the pod, get
Kieran, get up
the
here.
Pod.
Okay, I'm building him a fucking bridge. Hold on. Okay, get up here. There you go, there you go. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Fucking Christ. Jesus. That was our first mission of the night. It's almost been an hour. Well, good job, guys. Good job. Brent said, yeah, same. That was my one toxic encounter. Dude was refusing to continue a dungeon all because he wanted a single drop, so he booted him. Sounds like a WoW player. Oh, my God.
Imagine Woo! Doing that. Imagine being that fucking, like...
Honestly, okay. Though, goddamn. It's pretty cringe.
I mean, I know the drop rates for dungeon gear is terrible, but, like...
Yeah. It's always throwing been
a,
shit.
Throwing a bitch fit is not going to make it, not going to make the game give it to you any faster.
But it will increase my chances.
All right. Let's see if.
Mind if I will need.
There we go. Great fork armored. Okay, so there is a chance that they might be. Yeah, okay, I think it's happening. Oh, nope, Zach loaded in. Let's see if Kieran loads in. All right, well, let's see. I'm all done with mine. So, what do you got for yours, Zach? What assignment are you working on?
I was just doing a core hunt.
Oh, okay.
And I would have had this first mission done, but
I did not
happened.
I did not realize. Yes, like you fucking with the pipes. Who got leaf lovers?
No. I'm talking about my core hunt.
Oh, okay.
I had elimination, and I almost completed the first mission.
What happened? Well, were you warming up earlier?
Yeah.
What happened?
I was on the ramp.
Oh no.
I just realized I was muted the entire time.
Yeah, I just figured you were stuffing your face with pizza.
I mean, that's true. That's exactly what I'm doing right now.
You're perfectly honest. I just figured you weren't talking because there was pizza.
Alright, I think you might have gotten. You might have DC'd Kieran, so I'll invite you back in or you can join back in. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I'll join back in just a wee second.
You are all good, my dude.
I have eaten pizza, so life is now. I am more calm. I am more chill. I am one with my friends.
Are we going to have PvP events happening, Kieran?
No, I'm actually going to heavily discourage that, as that is not useful for team.
I'm going to bite my tongue right now.
Why would you bite it? That sounds painful.
Because reasons. What assignment did you just pick up, Ben?
Oh, just one for a gun. Oh, wait. Someone, I'll be right back.
One for a gun? All right, perfect. We'll do that one. Need to get Ben new weaponry. Yeah, thankfully there's not much of a toxic community, which is so nice. People just want people to have fun. Yeah, it's always nice to see welcoming game communities. Honestly, that's why I love Deep Rock so much, is like any, like... There's assholes, especially as the game gets more popular. It's just going to happen. But a majority of like the missions, especially like the public matches, I don't think I've ever had a shit experience playing pubs. It's always the mission. It's always, and you can usually tell which ones like are more toxic than others. Like if they're like has five or whatever, I'm like, oh, must be at least player level 400 or whatever. No gold, only take one tick per supply. You'll get kicked if you disobey the rules. It's like, bruh. And versus the other lobbies of like, what's the matter, big boy? You never get your dick sucked by a glyphin before. those are the ones that I usually gravitate towards. You can usually tell.
Can't imagine why.
Yeah. All right. Okay, what are we... Oh, it's another refining mission. Perfect. Is that going to be our theme for tonight?
I think we have to refine our strategy.
Refine our strategy? Refine the fucking mission selection. Jesus Christ. That's what we really need to do. Right, let me see if I can get you in here. Are you online, Kieran? I do not see you. Oh, man. Okay. Let me see. Did I miss anything in chat before while we wait for Ben to get back? No, we're all good.
Okay, this is not happening.
Burning love.
Ooh. Burning love. I have not had this one in a minute.
Last one to finish is a pointy-eared leaf lover.
Oh, I needed that.
Having fun there, Zach. Oh, yeah. God!
It burns. It burns. Never felt better. Never felt
it
better.
Hurts so good. Never felt better.
Feeling much better now.
Feeling much better now. Ooh. Prince says, I got my Oracle Dice. Oracle Dice? How to do... Is this for anything in particular? Teach me the ways, Fern. How do they work?
You throw them at people.
Generally, yeah.
You challenge people to a game of Dungeon Dice Ball.
Kickstarter it back. Nice. Very nice. Recently got my backer kit for the Deep Rock board game. And I've been playing the shit out of it, you guys. It's so much fun. I spent a little bit on it, and I got the collector's edition, which has all the minis inside. I'm very pleased with it, and they're all standard gray minis, so we can paint them if we wish. And I've seen people paint them, and goddamn, it's so good. I'll post some of the ones that I've seen in the Discord later, but it's so fucking cool. Okay, you go in NG, Kieran? Is it time for me to go scout?
Hello, again.
Well,
hello.
Back.
How dare you?
Fucking dual
NG. I had to hold a small dog for a moment.
Hold the small dog.
Why did you have to hold dog?
Oh. So, she recently got, like, what's it called? Like, the surgery to make them, like, sterile.
Spayed, yeah.
Yeah, she got spayed. So she's, well, she's high as a kite. And on pain meds. But she's wearing, to make sure that she doesn't mess with her stitches, she's wearing these, like, onesies, and Mom had to get another one. Just a backup, just in case.
Yeah. It happens. Let's see. Ooh. I'm gonna try out a new overclock for the shoddy. We're actually gonna try magnetic pellet alignment. I'm gonna see what all the hubbub's about.
No, you're
not.
What's up? What you looking for?
Where's the weapon shop?
Right over here.
Is it?
Yeah, what are you trying to do? I'm trying
to get the sludge gun.
That one is for on the assignment board here. I think you already picked up the assignment for it?
I do.
Have you completed the assignment for it?
It just says it's available for purchase.
Go do your driller. Oh, over here on the equipment thing.
And then you should be able to select the poop gun to purchase at the equipment
over here.
Right over here.
It was just there. It wouldn't let me. It says it's locked.
Do you have enough to purchase it?
No, as in, it's unlocked this at the assignment board.
And you've completed the assignment, right?
No, because the assignment says purchase the gun.
You have to complete the assignment first before you are able to purchase the gun, Ben.
Okay, but it doesn't say what else the assignment is.
Well, these are the missions that we have to complete.
Yeah, let's see.
Do you have a currently active assignment right now?
No. This is the only action I want.
No, there we go. Yeah, you've got a mission to do.
Yeah, that's the one I have selected right now.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, you're all good.
This game in like a year or two.
it's been a couple years, so you're all good. You're all good. I wanted this so bad. All right, Kieran's getting the look assembled. We got some spare burning love if you liked some flaming brew. What do we have? Rocky Mount? I don't think we're going to need that. We should be fine. I'm going to stay NG. I'll keep my field medic build up. It seemed to do us well before.
I'm going to go make Fern food real quick.
Sounds good.
Feel free to do whatever.
All right. I'm just chilling, waiting for you guys. Let's see. Fern said there are 21 D6s and 1 D12, and each face of each die is different and comes with their own meanings. And if you use the dice like tarot for oracular, I'm assuming oracular. I'm going to sound whatever. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Leave on the mission? What do you mean leave on the mission? What are you talking about, Eden? Stuff and advice by throwing them over a special cloth. Ooh, that's pretty cool. So it's just like another way to read tarot. That's pretty sick. Leave Zach behind. Okay, well, at this point, I'm just waiting for Kieran to assemble the look. I see you have a similar vibe going, Kieran. I like it. I see you, Kieran. Like that. Rock and roll. We gonna be the medics for this mission, or are we gonna make sure these boys come home? Rock and
stone, brother. Sure, why not?
He says as he loads up his grenade launcher. Can bring them to your house this week and do some readings. Yes, please. I would love to see how they work. Read my future, Fern. Tell me what my story holds for me. All right, that's this weekend. Oh God, I'm interested to see how that party's gonna go. It's gonna be fun. Hopefully, it won't be too hot. Let me actually check the weather.
Sorry.
75 is the high. It's hot, but it's not like what it's been the past few days. Yes, you finally get to come over to the ranch. That's going to be a hoot. Oh, hold on. Are we throwing mugs at Zach? Give me a sec.
Yeah.
All right, let's do this shit, boys. We're leaving Zach in the drop pod when we get there. Rock and stone. It never gets old. Leave no thought. Where is the best? All righty. Yes, Kieran. What do we have for our icebreakers? Do you have them prepared, or are you letting your food settle for a moment?
Yes, I'm prepared. Okay. What category would you like, Mr. General? We have our usuals, the tame, the let's start a fight, and deep in emotion.
Oh boy. We'll go surface level, and then I think I'll progress towards the deeper. So let's start with tame. Let's start with tame.
What TV show friend group is most like yours?
Oh no. Oh, that's a... Oh, God. I don't know how to answer this question! I've been grabbed. Because there's a lot of TV group, friend groups that are just fucking assholes.
And we are...
eagerly awaiting my answer. I have to think about that, because there's a few that are coming to mind. I don't know if I can justify answering this question, because I don't really watch that much TV with, like, friend groups that match our vibe, you know? Because the only ones that I've really watched from, like, for a good chunk of seasons are Friends. I watched that with Eden. I watched a good chunk of Big Bang Theory when I was in high school, much to my regret these days. What other friend groups have I seen? I've seen bits and pieces of How I Met Your Mother, but not enough to really know the characters that well. What other, like, TV friend groups have I noticed? I don't know. I don't know if I can answer that.
Well, there we go. First question out of the game, and Jonah can't answer it.
Do you have an answer?
What an apostrophe. Catastrophe.
What an apostrophe. I like apostrophe. I like the pog plants. Is it not the mystery gang? I guess based off that, I would have to say the mystery. We are most like the mystery gang.
There's more than five of us, though.
Well, then I can't answer the question, Kieran. All I'm saying is I get dibs on either Shaggy or Scooby. I'm nothing like Fred, Daphne, or Velma. I could maybe take Fred. That's a lie. Okay, I'm feeling the change in terms of the fire rate. Well, who would you say, Kieran? Who would you say? And I'm curious.
So I'm sure you haven't seen it yet, so...
It's a show I haven't seen yet. Does it go to a different school? Oh, Jesus.
It's in Canada, actually.
It's in Canada? Is it an actual show, or are you fucking with me?
No, it's an actual show.
Well, then what is it? Explain it to me. I would like to know.
No.
Okay. Thanks, Kieran.
I refuse to answer this question.
What? Okay. What's happening in chat?
I will tap rule one.
Okay, you're tapping rule one. Where is that spitballer coming from? It's spitting somewhere. Spit on him. There it is.
Damn it.
I have a shotgun sniper rifle. What am I doing? Okay. But who is Jonas Scooby Doo? And Eden says, Kieran has a thought, but won't share it. Classic Kieran. Oh, good. Another meteor. It's just the repeat of the last mission. Well, Zach will be here shortly, so. All right. What's happening, Fruit Sushi? Browsing Best of Nextdoor on Twitter, and this is a wild ride. Oh, no. What do you have? What do you have, Fruit Sushi? What's new in the Twitterverse? Not infested! Not again! Not again! Not again! Well, that happened. I look down and there's just a massive cluster. Hey guys.
I'm alive.
Yeah, but they're still here, so be careful. Thank you, Kieran. Hope you brought extra ammo.
I still hear some.
Yep, there's some on the walls. Okay, there goes that one. Fortunately, with how their nades work, they should take each other out if they get the explosive one going. Come on, come up over the fucking ridge. There you go. There goes that one. Ow! Ow! Whoa! I got you, soldier. I got you. Get up. I mean, next door is Twitter for Karen, so what isn't happening? Please, I want to hear what the Karens are saying. On the Karen, I want to know what's going on in the Karenverse. All right. Do you have an answer for that question, Ben? What TV show friend group is your friend group like? If you can't answer it.
I have to think about it. It's like... Because, like, I can't think of any, like, friend group from a show that, like, my friends fit, like, you know.
Right?
Even, like, in the loosest sense. Dude, fuck off.
Is there another flea near you? Oh, God. We got a normal meteor and a meteor shower. What the actual fuck?
What killed me?
Probably a fester flea. I'm coming. Provided the meteor doesn't get me first. Where the fuck is Zach? All right, hold on, guys, I'm coming.
there is a flea next to Karen.
Oh God! All right, back to work, gentlemen, back to work. He's about to join. All right, cool. Let's see if Zach has an answer for this question. I'm curious to see if Zach has one.
He looks like he does not.
I mean, that's a tough one to answer because there's a lot of, like, I don't know. Yeah.
Well, it's just like I can't think of any friend group from like any show I've watched that like even kind of fits.
I just don't want to say the Big Bang Theory. I just really do not want to say the Big Bang Theory. Okay.
But is it correct?
In terms of interests, yes. In terms of personality, I don't think so. I really hope not. Oh God, we have Praetorians. Okay. I'm just trying to mine gold, man. But it's okay. All that matters from this question is that chat believes that we are the mystery gang. And I am Scooby-Doo. So you know what? I'm happy with that. I can
all
do with
eight
that.
Of us are the five-person mystery gang.
Behind you.
I got Shredder Squad going up.
I question chat's math.
Well, consider how often, how many people we, like max people that we can get into one lobby for stream, Kieran. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, get back. There's an oppressor.
Exactly. And also, Eden's question, that makes sense. What TV group has eight people? Ow, I'm down.
The Office, Parks and Recreation, a Community, Abbott Elementary.
Yeah, but like, I've watched at least Parks and Rec, and half of those people hate each other. Like, not even in a friendly friend way, like a, I despise you as a person. From what I remember.
Oh God, we got mines covered on my position.
I mean, I can't speak to The Office in general, but there always seems to be a general cohesiveness towards the various other members of the groups.
I guess.
What, Amos? What, who do we despise?
Our question. There's what? watch the ceilings, guys. There's cave leeches. Be careful. I'm also down.
Not again.
Zach, we might need
I'm
your help.
I'm on my way.
Watch the ceilings.
Praetorian. Oh.
And for Praetorians.
You asked for an example where there was more than five people. I list off like five examples.
Eden says, imagine if someone told you that you were Scully from Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
I hope I'm no one from Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
That means I got a best bud in Hitchhiker.
That's true. That is very true. At least you have that.
What happened?
You got launched. Congratulations. You now have a roost. I saw that, Ben.
I don't like being up here. I'm a mole, not a bird.
You are now a mole bird. Congratulations.
We're a mole, really confused as to how it got up here.
Okay, wait, get away from that.
Oh, nice. There we go. All right. Help.
So what, Ennis?
Kieran asked the question, what TV show friend group is most like yours? As our first question. And it's a hard question to answer because, yeah, there's a lot of like TV shows with a large cast, right? But I don't know if any of them really fit us, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, Kieran has one for a show in Canada that goes to another school.
That easy. Refuses to allow.
But he doesn't want to answer. I'm assuming because he doesn't want to like go into like the details of like the show or whatever, which is fine. He's invoking rule one, which is you don't have to elaborate on the question. You can just say that you have something.
Hey Ben, could I get your drilling expertise over here?
Okay, we got supply pods. Thank you.
But let me make it easier for you to get up here. Okay, I made a zip line for you to come up here.
Where?
Behind the...
Mark where, because I cannot otherwise see it.
I fired it over your head.
I think we're actually doing that, right. That you did you just miss what I said?
I need you to drill that direction.
Oh God, Eden said TV friend group, easy. Ed and Eddie. Oh no.
Because in that direction is the rock cracker pods.
Yeah, you know what?
It'd be a lot easier if we just drilled to them instead of having to go all the way around.
So am I going the right direction?
Yes, slightly more downward. You know what? This is good.
Hey, guys.
Hey, guys.
How y'all doing?
This is good. Thank you, Ben.
Well, I was trying to make it like a ramp.
Yeah.
Then that makes me characteristically a moron. Bold of you to assume that you are Ed, John.
Okay, but is he Ed or is he Ed?
I think he's Eddie. All right, where are the fucking gunksy? They're lost in a sea of barrels over here. Jesus Christ. All right. Well, I think we've answered that one plenty. Who's next, Kieran? Who do we have next for what category?
Mr. Zach.
I want to start a fight.
Always a good lad. I can always rely on you. You're good old Zach.
I guess I wasn't good enough. Oh, well.
You didn't want to start a fight.
I wanted to start from the surface. That's okay. That's on me. Okay.
No, that question engages in stereotypes. We're not asking that one. Let's see.
I'm gonna curve this one around.
Jonah, I'm making an abomination, and you can't stop me.
I can't because I'm busy making my own pipeline. So you know what? You have fun.
We can't stop him, but we can beat him.
See, Ben, you have this thing called satchel charges. So you're gonna have to be in charge of. Oh, spoke too soon. I guess.
I am being grabbed.
I got you.
Nice. Winter Wonder. Oh, come the fuck on. God damn it.
Where did that come from?
Chat fucks me over yet again. Ow. Ow.
Alright, Zach.
I'm sealing up this pit. Here comes the blizzard.
Alright, Kieran.
What is something you don't get the hype about?
Ooh.
That I don't get the hype about.
Yes. You don't understand why so many people are excited about it.
Oh, God. Can't fucking see.
I didn't think about that one.
I can answer that one. If you want me to, Zach.
Sure. Give me time to think.
I'm gonna say a bold one. Star Trek. Never got into it. Never got into it. Probably never will. I understand that people enjoy it, and that's fine. I have no problem with that. I'm not a Star Trek hater. Jesus Christ, no.
Okay.
I'm not denying that it has. Yeah.
Okay. Now we're fine.
But it's more of the fact that I never got into it and probably never will because I was mainly. Like when I was growing up, at least I'm sure that you can enjoy both this and the other thing. But you were either a Trekkie, or you enjoyed Star Wars. You can enjoy both for certain, but I was a Star Wars kid, and
see, we were kind of raised as both.
Yeah, which I see, and that makes sense. And there's nothing wrong with that. I just never got into it, and I don't understand. I never watched it. I'm sure it's cool. I just never did it. You know.
Oh. Okay, that is okay.
That is acceptable
because of my namesake. I am like honor bound to dispute you if you said that Star Trek was bad.
No, I'm sure it's cool. I just never watched it, and I probably never will.
Since the parameter of this is to start a fight, I don't get by on.
Oh,
don't get what?
It just seems like a waste of time. Honestly.
Bionicle. He said he doesn't get by.
Well, you can say whatever wrong.
You are allowed to have an opinion. It may be wrong, but you are allowed to have that opinion.
It may be wrong objectively, factually, spiritually.
Trying to put a lot of hype and action around it. They're just little bits of plastic.
D&D
is rolling plastic rocks around and saying words.
Uh-oh.
Everything sounds dumb when you reduce it down.
Oh no! It's working.
You can make anything sound stupid if you like just reduce it. Yeah.
You absolutely can, and I understand that basic concept. But I will say this: Bionicles does nothing to draw you in.
Ben's literally like, I'm calling the police.
I'm showing a lot of. I'm restraining myself.
This question is meant to start a fight. Am I not starting a fight, sir?
Fern says,
I understand the objective of the goal, or of the question, but however.
Fuck you.
However. Fuck you, I hate you, and I hate your opinion. And your opinion is stupid and Bellman bad. And,
See, Kieran, I chose the diplomatic route for my answer to this question, and I feel like I got off pretty easy. Kieran went in fucking full blast, like, you know what? Fuck this thing.
I never did.
Yeah, fair enough. You know what? That's your answer, and there you go. Fern says, for me, I can't get the hype around Halo. I respect that people love it, just ain't my thing.
Oh my god.
Oh no. I mean,
if you never experienced Halo as it came out, and most of, like, modern Halo, current Halo, is not doing itself any favors on being likable.
Oh yeah.
The campaign is okay, and everything else is just bad.
Yeah.
I really liked the story.
Yeah, but it's still got issues.
There's issues, but it's not. I feel like with the Halo Infinite campaign, it tried to do a lot, and I think they were very overambitious with it.
I mean, I felt more like they were trying to start from square one again, because 5 kind of fucked things.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Okay, not to downplay 5, but 4 also did bungle a bunch of shit unnecessarily.
Oh, yeah. There's no doubt about that.
I'm always going to be mad about it, but every Halo game has been building up to the... been saying almost outright that humanity is the Forerunners.
Yeah.
4 fucks that up.
Yeah.
For no reason, and suddenly everything is stupid and doesn't make any sense, because now all this technology that wasn't built by humans works for humans.
Just as a quick side note, we do have a pickaxe overcharge sprinkler for those who are promoted. So before we start the refinery, let's get that done. We also have a dreadnought, by the way, so just be mindful.
Yeah, I'm aware.
Is it over in your guys' pit?
He is over with me.
Coming. Treasure squad, go! All right. Well, I think we've answered that plenty. Here we go. Fern said, oh no, I did experience when it first started. My dad got an Xbox solely for Halo. I was there from the start. I grew up watching my dad play the games. I just couldn't get the hype. Yeah, that's fair.
It's
not for everybody.
Yeah, there is taste.
That being said, cringe. Play Halo, it's really good.
I will still always consider the first game just like a masterpiece.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
I mean, oh god, we can talk all day about
it. I love the other ones, yeah. But I think 1 is always just going to be my favorite.
Really?
1 is good, but come now. We all know it's Halo 2.
Yeah, Halo 2. What about Halo 2, Ben?
I hate that. Halo 2 suffers from issues. Balance, like, campaign-wise, I feel. The Brutes are not fun to fight.
That's fair. That's absolutely fair. They're a bitch and a half to fight.
Now, assuming we're playing on Heroic. Because normal is out of the question for some of us. Normal is out of the question.
Jackal snipers.
Jackal snipers, even on Heroic, and the Brutes, again, they're just not fun. They're bullet sponges. They slap you around.
Yeah.
Like, I get what they were going for, but it's in practice. I hate it.
Yeah, I get that. That being said, the story, I think, in my opinion, probably Halo 2. Halo 2 is definitely the best out of all of them. 3 was 3 was great, but I have a lot of memories playing Halo 3 campaign over and over and over again when it came out.
Oh, but yeah, for sure.
2 as a story is undisputed GOAT, in my opinion.
Keith David,
yeah. All right, let's gather around the pickaxe sprinkler, or are we taking care of the dreadnought first?
What can we mean? Please kill the dreadnought?
Okay.
Yeah, let's deal with
it. He's kind of been clowning on me.
Okay, speaking of clowning on you guys, I feel like we answered that question pretty good, but we still have to wait for 2 answers. Zach, do you have an answer for that question?
I can't think of any. I can't bring any to mind.
What about you, Ben? Is there just something you don't get the hype about?
Genshin Impact.
Thank you, Ben. Thank you. Finally, someone said it.
Every time I see that brought up because, oh, they're releasing a new character or whatever, I don't care. It sucks.
It's just little anime Breath of the Wild. That's all it is to me.
The characters... It's the same problem Overwatch does. I guess I'm swinging at 2 things. In that they make a cool character concept and then never do anything with it ever because they only need the concept to get your money.
Okay, quick side tangent. Speaking of Overwatch, did you guys hear what happened with Overwatch 2?
Oh, yeah.
The fucking PvE got canceled!
you want to hear the real bad part about it?
Mm.
It was canceled in 2021.
That's so sad. That is so sad.
It was
canceled. So they were never going to do that.
Nope.
It was canceled a year before they announced that it was canceled.
Oh my god.
So they just were never going to do it.
They were stringing people along for at least a year.
Oh no.
Of a game mode that they had sold this entire game on. Remember, that was the entire selling point of Overwatch 2.
I feel so bad for Gwangju. He got it like when it came out. He hasn't played since, but he was playing it for a little bit when it first came out, and I just
Where is that last? Oh, there it is.
No. Mark it. Is it dead?
In a second it will be.
Okay, I'm gonna go grab some supplies from this pit over here. There's a shit ton of supply pods, so feel free to restock up whenever you guys are ready. Eden's got some fighting words in chat. Star Wars. I love it for Jonah, but the logic doesn't make sense. I do love the awful writing in the movies. There are some great things, but has a lot of bad things. Sorry, Jonah. You know what?
I will agree with that.
I get that. I get it.
I think Star Wars is overrated.
Oh, absolutely. But I still love it.
Like, I like it, but also, I hope we stop getting things for it. I know that'll never happen while Disney is still a thing.
No,
but
it's
like, I am praying for the day that I stop seeing like Star Wars things come out.
Yeah.
Because
it's time for it to die.
They clearly, no one is allowed to do anything new or cool with it now.
And somehow Palpatine returned.
It's so cringe.
Not even that, because like, you can say that movie objectively is bad, but like,
yeah,
he was put, and that I just generally don't like the director because I don't like Hollywood people, mm-hmm. but he was put in a very terrible spot, and there was really no good decision he could make.
Yeah, okay. Eden said Mandalorian is good, but Obi-Wan and Boba Fett had some issues. Yeah,
Boba Fett just is meandering.
I will give you that. It does kind of meander.
They kind of neutered my boy. There were some cool moments, don't get me wrong. But a majority of that show was just mid at best.
My problem with a lot of Star Wars stuff is that, like, it's this really cool concept, and then they just don't fucking do anything with it.
Yeah.
They just fuck around with it for hours, and then...
Let's go gather up at the pickaxe overcharger, and then let's get the refinery started. As we continue to answer more of this, do you have any new answers for it, Zach? Or
no,
nah.
I'm trying to think of things, and I'm not.
I will say, Zach, you, the master of anti-hype, it is truly shocking to me that you don't have an answer for this.
Are there any franchises you might consider maybe?
Any franchises, any trends, any like anything, you know?
I'm
like,
thinking.
Any music?
I'm thinking.
While you think, I'm gonna go back and read some of the quotes from the Karens that Fruit Sushi's gathering right now.
Oh, But I understand the hype for warp. I just don't experience it because my brain is weird.
Well, there you go. Oh, what is it? What is it?
So, for some reason, usually right before an event, a large event, people get really hyped and really excited. I have the opposite reaction, and I don't know why.
Do you dread going to? So
it's, I don't, it's not that I dread it. It's that my energy drops.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Like, I just don't get excited for it. I'm just like, yeah, LARP is happening. That is a thing.
Are you? This is an event
that will be occurring in a few days.
It is the perpetual bane of my existence, and I never understand it. I love you, Zach. I do.
If anything, I get like pre-LARP drop rather than post-LARP drop.
Maybe you're conserving your energy or something. I don't fuck.
Hey. Mm-hmm. My brain's weird.
All right, let's gather up around this.
But I'm just like, I am a bundle of hype every time. But okay, that was my main reference to Zach. I'm like, you of all people have the answer to this question.
But I get the hype for it though, but I just don't physically experience it.
Yeah. Oh god! I got spat on.
So, got spat on.
Alright, well, there we go. Did you answer this question, Kieran?
Yes, he said Bionicle.
Oh, right, yes. Okay.
And I told him that he was objectively wrong.
The correct answer in all of this.
Sorry, my memory span's not helping me right now. Anyway.
It's okay. I will say this as a final comment. Zach?
Yeah?
Your edgy Legos have no business in this world.
Fuck you, Bionicle saved Lego!
And with that, let's move on to the next question for Ben.
Fuck you! We're gonna fucking save Lego.
All right, come on over here, Kieran. Here, take pipeline 3, and you'll be right next to it. We just want to make sure they all spawn right next to us.
1, 2, 3.
They're coming up over the ridge. Here they come. Use your pickaxes.
Commit Unga Bunga.
I have mining charges.
Will those actually work?
Do they?
I don't know.
No.
I don't think so.
Alright,
no.
I have. Oh. That okay. Works. I was gonna
run over
it.
There's little pickaxe.
Oh, yeah, the would do it.
Oh, yeah. So you can do that if you don't get any charges.
Well, no, the pick.
There you go. Yeah, this would work. The tipping comment. Oh, here we go. No, John, this is not Gunner Nom. Gunner Nom will be at the end of the month when we do Drunk Rock.
I need to get more lemonade for that.
Which you are more than welcome to join us for, Ben, if you would like to play some Gunner and get boozy.
Okay, so Ben is somewhere in that age range.
Halfway there. Yeah, let's get all these fucking barrels out of here. Jesus Christ.
I think that's what's launching us every now and then. Physics just have like a freak out.
And the best part
is absolutely what's happening.
The best part about it is the bugs can move the barrels too. So yeah, let's kick them onto like this pit back here or something. Okay, here comes a shit ton of them. Get your pickaxes ready.
Commit Unga Bunga.
Commit the Unga Bunga. Not the baker's dozen. Not the baker's dozen. You cease that shit. Chat. God damn it. Okay, I'm throwing out Shredder Squad. I'm not dealing with this shit right now. Stop it. Stop. Chat. Calm the fuck down.
If I hurt anyone in this crowd, it's your fault.
Oh, don't I know it? Every single week.
I claim no responsibility.
No, it's.
I will kill as many people as I have to, so long as you are one of them.
There we go, we did it. Hooray! Alright, let's find the fuck. Oh, God. Alright, right over here. Alright, come grab your cores, boys, for those who can grab them. Alright, what do I win? Alright, let's get NG, since I'm playing NG. Not infested! No!
Please tell me someone has Iron Will. Please tell me someone has Iron Will.
No!
At least I got my core! Yep.
That was too good.
Yep. I can't even be mad that killed everybody.
Slash.
Fucking slash kill.
Alright, no, you're right, Ben. I do need to space that one out. And I know we're gonna get them re-kitted in a week. But god damn it, I'm tweaking that right goddamn now.
Oh no, what I was saying is we need to space out. Like,
oh, well, I mean, there wasn't much that we could do anything.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Like in that area.
There? No. But like
Okay. Well, we have time now. Let's get the next question for Ben going, Kieran, while I go back up.
Oh, I have a lot of script to script.
Oh, there goes Kieran again.
Oh no!
You are our sacrificial lamb today, Kieran. All right, we're gonna change things up. We're gonna go kill some dreadnoughts.
Shit, new season starts in a month.
Right. So get your things done, because we're gonna be seeing some new shit. Okay. Well, it'll be in crates, so you're totally fine, Zach. I do need to be reading what Fruit Sushi has been posting for it. I agree. Let's see. We need to go back up from the very start. Okay. So from here. All right. Here we go. Spy flower. My neighbor has this flower peeking into my backyard. I couldn't get close enough to see if there is a camera hidden inside. Is this even legal? Attached is a picture of a sunflower showing over the top of a fence. Oh, this is some new tech. Okay. Urgent alert. Warning. All the avocados at Whole Foods are rock hard. Don't know why you are referred to her age. I'm an old woman who is sensitive about age discrimination. For God's sake, Judy, this isn't about you. Oh my god. There's a post about a chicken teddy bear and I can't communicate the full horror of it through text. This is enrichment. You put in your eldritch horror the shape... Wait, what the fuck? This is enrichment. You put your eldritch horror in the shape of a small child's enclosure. I think that might have just been something else. Here we go. When paying rent, what is customary to tip the landlord and leasing company? What the fuck? Oh my god. Here we go. Hello, I know everybody loves this time of year, but can everybody be considerate and turn your Christmas lights off at 7:30 p.m.? My cats are trying to sleep and they find your lights distracting. Oh, this one's good. What does LGBTQ mean? Is this an Antifa meeting? Shout out to the lady on my next door who posted an appeal for volunteers to come serve as waiters at her family's Thanksgiving. Oh, Jesus Christ, no. Okay, we're all caught up. Those are great. Jesus fucking Christ. It really is Twitter for Karens, isn't it? All right, I'm going to swap to fucking... I'm going to go Gunner on this one. I'll kill anything with more legs. We need the firepower. Oh, don't you fucking dare, chat. Don't do this to me. Don't do... Well, they got you covered, Kieran. God damn it. What's the brew? Tunnel rat? We're in magma core. We're probably gonna need that, aren't we? What do you think, Zach?
Probably.
Yeah. All right, Kieran, chat got leaf lovers for you.
Chat, I love you. Thank you. It's good to know that my opinions help bring people together.
Fuck you, Kieran.
All right, everybody, come help me empty the counter real quick.
I love you too, Zach.
Drink the water.
trending post, suspicious guy in neighborhood promoting, quote, voting. Suspicious.
What a suspicious gentleman indeed.
Suspicious guy in neighborhood promoting democracy. All right, come get your tunnel rats. Drink up, everybody. But yes, Kieran, do you have our next category?
Yes.
I think it's Ben's turn, right?
If he would like to go, if he does not wish to go, he does not have to.
I'll
take this one. It's up to you, dude.
We enter this house, take hesitations, and I don't know as no's.
Yeah, okay. Then I'll just pass.
We will not assume consent. All right. Mr. Jonah.
All right. Enough of this light bullshit. Let's get deep. Get deep with me, Kieran.
Oh.
I'm ready. Let's be vulnerable with each other. And while we be vulnerable with each other, I'm going to go to the bathroom.
Oh, I see it. Dipping right away.
You guys are into that.
Do you understand a word he said?
No.
I think what he said was
agreement.
Yes, I think we all understood that very thoroughly.
Yeah. Right, Ben?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see.
I'm back. All right. See, I told you it wouldn't take long. All right.
Nope.
While you get that, we have a couple more from Fruit Sushi. Trending, urgent alert. I'd like to report a crime. People in our neighborhood still have their Halloween decorations up. Is this a recent post or is it like... Here we go. I don't think I can fully replicate the glory of this, quote, vegan radius post. I'll drop it in the meme channel on Discord. Perfect. All right, that's what we have so far.
I can't answer this question because I'm not in one. So... I was asking a relationship question. It's like, talk about it. No.
Fair enough. Pull a new one. You're asking the questions. You're the one who determines what gets asked and what gets answered.
Chad asked that question. He's in the chat.
He's in the chat?
The fuck does that mean?
It's him. Him is here. Karen should not be allowed online. Yeah. For sure. It's him. Yes, John, I agree. It is him.
Him.
The guy. The one and only guy. In his vulnerability being asked personal questions, John decided now is the perfect time to be vulnerable himself by flushing a toilet inside the space rig space bathroom. Oh, God. Okay. Has it been posted already? The vegan radius post? All right, give me a second. While Kieran searches. Let me know when you have it, Kieran.
Oh. What details do you know about the day you were born?
That my mom was in labor with me for an ungodly amount of time. I forget the specifics.
Same.
That I practically ripped her open with how big and heavy I was. As for emotional beats, I don't know. All I know is I think I was just short of 10 pounds, if not 10 pounds. I'd like to think I was 10 pounds, but I'm pretty sure I was like 9 pounds and however many ounces, just short of a pound. Beyond that, it's been a while since I've heard any stories about the night I was born. That's pretty much what I got.
Mostly I have the "you took 13 hours to be born" that my mom has never let me live down, ever.
I mean...
13 hours, Zach.
13 hours!
And that was not the first time I attempted to be born.
There's always a response to this, though.
Yeah.
They chose for that.
That is how you get your ass kicked.
I have answered that to Bob. Doesn't have an answer back.
And it's basically, you took 13 hours, and whose fault was that?
Yeah, like, you had the kid, ma'am.
You're the one who was pedante.
What about you? What about you, Kieran?
Taking 13 hours to decide if he's born or not is a very sad move.
Here's the fun thing, Kieran. It was not the first time I attempted to be born.
It's not his fault for trying. He did try.
I tried, and then they said no, so I was like, fine, I'm not doing it.
38 plus 2 will be...
Reganonat! Yeah.
Okay. We feeling the vibes tonight, each other, or do we want something super tame for my story? Because I have two versions of it.
Oh, okay. Hold on. I'm going to make a poll real quick. So we have tame, or what was the other category, Kieran?
Tame and wholesome, and then the deep truth.
Tame. Okay, here we go. Tame, wholesome, and deep truth. Oh no. Which story of Kieran's birth will we hear? Okay. All right, you got a minute, chat. Get voting. Go. Let me see. While they vote, I will read chat's responses to this. Gamma said, it took me 23 hours to get out, and I literally broke bones within my mom, about 13 pounds, 11 ounces. Jesus Christ. I was like the size of a toddler. Fritzy says, I was a crazy 8 baby. Needen says, we have a video of my siblings hearing I was born. So the doctor was surprised at how small I was and how fast I came out. And friend said, I know that I was born at midnight and my mom was in labor for 24 hours. And yee, that's what we have. All right, what do we have? All right, so far we got votes for deep truth. That's what we got. So prepare for to tell that story. No one's going for tame and wholesome. This is perfect.
I appreciate this chat. Okay, well,
all right, deep and truth wins it. There you go.
So, for frame of reference, I was, in theory, supposed to be the last kid of most of my family. For those of you who know my family, I was the fourth to last of the family. But I was supposed to be the last because my mom, truthfully, as lovely as she is, wanted to stop at 3 children. Mm-hmm. I thought that was enough for her life.
Mm-hmm.
And especially considering what she went through to have me, it's no surprise. For those of you who are not familiar, there is this disease known as preeclampsia that develops usually after the 20th week of a person being pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
And it basically causes high blood pressure, it can cause the kidneys and liver to not work normally. It's basically a very painful experience on top of what you're already doing.
Sorry.
Darn near killed my mother.
Jesus.
Now, here's the thing. She had already had preeclampsia once before in 1985. And for reference, this kills 2 out of 3 women who have it. She had it 3 times.
Jeez. My God.
The first time around, they didn't even know exactly what it was. And the second time around, which was with me, they knew exactly what it was, but they didn't really know how to stop it.
Well, that's a thing.
They were like, hey, we know exactly what you have this time around, but medical research hasn't really dictated what we can do to fix this problem. So it's just going to happen.
So good luck.
Fern asks, Kieran, is your mom just a superhero?
She 100% is. Like, yeah. Legit. And anywho, so my mom is going through this, And the doctors, in very traditional doctor fashion, are more prioritizing saving me, the baby, and not so much taking care of my mom, because, again, 2 out of 3 women die with this, and they don't know how to fix this, so they kind of assume she's a lost cause at this point.
Damn.
She would go on to not be a lost cause, as she would have a brief moment of flatlining on the delivery table. We are in labor, and she distinctly remembers that my father was in the room, insisting to her that she not leave, because she said that she finally felt comfortable, that all the pain was like leaving her, and that she could actually like rest finally. And my father was insisting that she keep fighting, and she was like, fine, I guess I'll live.
I guess, you know.
If you insist.
I have to. I'll come back kicking and screaming.
So, my mom has. I am a very temperamental baby, so they have to do a C-section. I am born. I won't stop screaming. I was a very loud and vocal child. Not the loudest, my mom attests. That belongs to my oldest brother. He was the most aggressive. But I was definitely a bit of a wake-up call that this shit can't be happening. And then 3 years later, she had my younger brother Gabriel, and it happened again.
My God.
It never ends. Oh, man. Fruit Sushi says your mom can no longer be stopped by man or God, Kieran.
Anywho, so first night of having me, as soon as it was done, like, we have... I mean, and at the hospital, it's like, hey, you've had the baby. We want to discharge you right now.
What kind of fucking hospital?
All right, you're done. Get out.
Fuck off.
Next.
And she's kind of like,
pit. Watch the pit here.
I nearly just died. So.
Yeah, but did you die, though?
For the first 24 hours of my life, they had to find a temporary substitute, but my mom was put isolated in a hotel room with me and the baby.
Oh my God.
For extra thing, they didn't really entirely understand a whole lot of exactly how the disease my mom had worked. There's a few concerns of what could possibly happen, so they kept her isolated from the rest of her family.
Ooh, so, careful, Ben.
Yeah.
So...
just figure out how to get around.
There's a thing right here.
The woozy woman, after about, you know, an arduous labor, gave birth to a child that she was left alone in a hotel room, who was screaming his head off, told that she can't see the rest of her family, and having nearly died, you know, it's a lot.
That's a lot to take in. Jesus.
Yeah.
And, but it does have a happy ending. Obviously, I was born, hooray, much joy was happened, and then my younger brother Gabriel was born under similar circumstances, but by that point, after beating a disease that, again, is supposed to kill 30
should have killed her already!
Like, several times over, she actually started a foundation specifically to research this disease and figure out how to deal with it.
That's so fucking cool. Holy shit.
In fact, if you Google the Preeclampsia Foundation, she is listed as one of the founders for it.
Wow.
Damn.
And she wrote a book about it, so it's a pretty, you know, amazing experience. And, you know, I often say that, you know, I feel especially fortunate that I have a mother who I genuinely love and care about, and she is a fucking super. At the end of the day, like, truly. There are so many health problems that have come her way that demand to kill her, and she has somehow persevered through all of that. We were very much told from an early age that she was not going to live past my 5th birthday, and here
she's still
I am.
Here. Yeah.
And Jonah can attest, having met her, that she is a pretty nice person, I would say.
She's fucking cool, dude. Like.
But, just the story of how I was born. My mom always does this kind of embarrassing thing where every single birthday of mine, she's like, this year, on this day, I nearly died giving birth to my own my beloved sons.
And you're like, yes, 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 we've heard it 1,000 times.
Listen, you can only hear about your mom dying 25 times before you're kind of like, okay.
We get it.
We get it. We get it. You died. Woo! But in all seriousness, it's an insane. That's an insanely cool story. Yeah. As tragic as that nearly could have been. Holy shit!
Your mom's kind of badass.
Your mom's a badass, dude, and she's awesome. She's sweet. You got a good mom, man.
I appreciate some folks tipping that, and I could send it her way. She was really like doesn't always feel that way.
Well, she should. So you know what. Let it be known if she ever somehow watches this stream.
Oh, I have Fat Man loaded into this.
Oh no!
I thought I had Hyper Propeller loaded in here.
Well, I mean, you don't. So it's a good thing I have a shield generator. All right, there's a lot of things that flew by in chat. I think it's. Let me see. Hold on, real quick. More. Oh, God. Fern said, oh, and also the volcano that I share my dead name with erupted on the day I was born, and it was also the city's pride parade that day, which marched right by our window. Oh, shit! And then it's more Karen posts, which I will get to once we are done, but please, Fruit Sushi, keep them coming. Keep them coming. Where did Ben go? Ben?
Ben is soloing the dreadnought.
Where are you? Where did you? It's not showing you. Oh dear.
No one else is fighting it.
Oh, I see. Okay, I'm coming. I got burned to a crisp. Hey, guys. Hey, guys. We might need a little help. Oh boy. Thank you. Okay. It is on its way. That should help it. There we go. Oh, fuck. I threw that right as it. Okay. Cool. What? I got it aggroed. I got some mines set up. Be careful. Oh, no. Oh, no. Nice. I saw that. Was that you, Ben?
Yeah.
Good shit.
Good one.
Good shit. Yeah. That knocked out
how
a ton of armor.
Hurt it? Okay, cool.
Come on, Dreadnought. I'm about to turn you into Boromir. Eat crossbow.
Dude.
Not again.
I got him.
I almost froze him.
Get up, soldier. Keep fighting. The amount of friendly fire like lines that I've heard. Oh, good freeze, nice. good freeze. Oh no. Ah. That's not so good.
It keeps doing that damn AoE.
Hold on, guys, hold on. Cool, we got more shields.
Okay, I'm about to drop.
I got you. Turrets are taking care of it, we're all good.
Drop, you bitch!
Nice! Kieran was in on that one. Holy fuck. Okay. Oh my god!
Make it stop!
Okay, guys, we have. Oh no.
We need resupply. We need supplies.
Yes, we do. Get away from the meteor!
Hey, wonderful husband, could you give us some stuff?
Do we have any supporters in chat, please? We could use some ammo down here.
How do we not have enough nitro?
Because we pretty much just went straight to the dreadnought.
We have red sugar right here. Come get some red sugar. I killed a red sugar baby. Oh, there we go. We got a supply pod. Okay. Thank you, Eden, for the bait and switch.
Is it the big ones or is it the small ones?
It's the small ones.
Okay, that's.
I'm going to. That's on, not man. Support.
He's supporting our liver failure.
I have 50 nitro on me. Do we have any? Oh, Jesus.
And then he's supporting the failure of our livers.
Lootzilla! Get out of here, Lootzilla!
What the fuck?
Oh, God. Dusky Trigger. What the fuck is going on? Okay. shake and quake. This is fine. This is not fine. My feet are on fire. Okay.
I am hidden myself. I am completely safe.
Fruit Sushi says, I am supporting absolutely nothing. You're welcome. Oh, good. Cave leeches.
Elk, by the way.
Where are you?
Elk.
Oh. Hold on. Hold up! I'm getting blasted by a sand butthole. I don't know if I can help you, Kieran. Give me a second.
Okay.
Okay, I'm right under you. Fall.
Why won't anybody help?
Fall. You need to... I can't...
Come on. Wait, why are you kidding? I'll help.
Oh, not this. I get... No! I'm lighting up these fucking fleas.
Oh, shit. Son of a bitch.
Getting out of the tunnel. Get up. Get out of the tunnel. Get out of there. Okay, we're gonna hold this choke point for a minute.
I swear, every time I turn the corner and see a festival plate, it's like that one scene in Alien where you're just kinda like, oh, shit.
It just wants to give you a hug here, just like the Xenomorph.
It just wants to hug your insides.
Ow.
It just wants to give your internal organs a hug.
Yeah, let's get some breathing room.
God damn it, I got frozen!
Skill issue.
Oh god. Not the eggs. No! Ooh!
Right. Mr. Zach.
I'm down.
Why is everyone dead?
I don't think we're making it out of this one, chat. Chat.
We ain't making it out.
Are we starting to fight, Zach?
Yes.
There is a nemesis somewhere, so be aware.
I'm out! Here we go!
Oh, but I'm trying to ask a question.
Too bad!
You can ask a question when you go down.
That was not an invitation!
Oh no, there we go. Alright. Chat, Guanju in particular is feeling very spicy tonight. Oh boy. Yeah, we're really feeling the revives not being here anymore. Good lord. All right, well now you have time to look for the question, Kieran, and I have time to catch up on Karen Twitter. Let's see. I think it was this one. Okay. Can someone recommend a good podiatrist? Is that what it is? Thanks. My son likes feet. He looks at pictures of them all day on his computer. Oh, maybe no. He could take a look. Is this a coyote? It might just be the angle, but it looks bigger than a coyote to me. It ate all the cushions off my patio furniture. Attached is a picture of what is clearly an elk. is this a coyote? To the little girl that threw a fully grown adult potato at my head this evening, I hope you are happy with yourself. I hope you had a good laugh when that potato bounced off my car and hit me again. I am a proud family man and Lexus owner and don't deserve vegetables flying at my head. This town has taken a turn for the worst. Thank you.
Help. I hope another kid throws a potato at
me. They need more potatoes, clearly. Help, clearly. People have been walking in front of my house. This must stop. It's driving my dogs crazy.
Oh, boo fucking boo. Deal with it.
$40 garage foundation, you move. Does it come in any other color? No, it doesn't, Dale. Serious inquiries only, Dale. Okay, we got a few more. Flags. On my 2.5 miles with my dogs, I saw a grand total of 13 American flags flying. I was hoping to see more. Your emojis are the Liberian flag. Please stop cooking. I can smell the cooking and it triggers my undiagnosed allergies. Please do not cook your food, but instead opt for foods that do not require cooking. I think I've seen this one before, like carrot sticks and grape nut seeds. If cooking is absolutely necessary, please consider the following options. 1. not cooking. 2, eating food naturally.
Have you considered option 3? Fucking starve.
Have you considered option 3? Grow your own farm inside your house. All right, that mission was awful. Let's try. God, all of our missions are in.
We want to do it again.
We're going to try. We're going to try this one for Kieran in the sandblasted corridors. And then we'll give another swing at your mission for the poop gun, Ben.
All right.
Okay, but yes, we currently have our... Yes, Fern, it was Goldblade who did remove the revives. I need to read the vegan post. Yes, yes, Gam, it was Goldblade that removed revives. Because people were using it to, like, just...
Scum finish. Shit.
Yeah, scum shit. They were doing one-bit revives to get quick cash.
They were being scum.
It was fucking bullshit, and it ruined it for everybody else. So, thank you, Twitch streamers. Real great representation of our community. Anyway, I will read the vegan post while Kieran gets the start a fight question. Unless you have it, Kieran. Nice. Oh, God. Chicken teddy bear? Jesus Christ! That's terrible! Okay. Here we go. Vegan radius. Last night, around 18:30 p.m., we spotted our neighbors in their yard barbecuing what looked like raw flesh. Steak emoji, we are vegan. Broccoli emoji, plant emoji, 2 angry emojis in a row. We have had in-depth discussions with our neighbors about our veganism and the importance of a vegan community and the importance of living in a meat-free radius. Not only was it disturbing to watch, but the scent wafted into our house minutes after. Sickened emoji, crying emoji, to each their own, but feeling unsure about what to do next. Side eye emoji. How would you respond to this? Would love to spark a discussion. Exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark.
Why are there so many exclamation marks?
They're in emojis of 2 exclamation marks each, so
Who does that? You either use 1 or 3.
Giving a real good name to all vegans out there.
Yep.
Can you give me this medal? I'm vegan. You got me, Ben. You got me.
It has been for ever since I watched that, and like I instantly just
can you give me this medal? Hey,
can you give me this medal?
Can you give me this? I'm vegan. Take your headphones off.
I'm vegan.
What an age! What an age of YouTube! Holy fuck! I mean,
this question seems very topical.
Here we go. All right.
Oh no!
Oh boy!
Let's do it.
If you had to pick one. Key thing had to.
Okay.
What is the worst type of Karen?
What is the worst
Karen?
Type of Karen?
Karen?
Karen.
Oh God. Oh, can we get a nice like categorical wow, I cannot speak.
Categorical,
thank you. Thing for Karens. Like when we say type of Karen, like let's establish what types of Karens there are. I can't speak English tonight. I'm so sorry, everybody. English is horrid.
You are working retail, and something minor goes wrong.
Okay.
What is the worst reaction a Karen has ever given?
I had one who act like I fucking shot her dog when I said, you can't send this in a plastic bag. We can't use that. And she was like, okay, you don't have to yell at me. Ma'am, I'm just speaking at a regular volume. You're the idiot who didn't read your Amazon instruction.
My God. I think I've told this story before. I've had somebody come through who, they like... When I was working at Safeway, we worked near like the back of the store, right? In our fruit cutting department. And there was like a thing of like a giant water thing that people could go take jugs to, fill up, go buy it at the counter and take it home, whatever, right? Someone decided to fill their, I think it was like a water bottle or something, which I don't know if that was necessarily against store policy, but I don't know. It wasn't my thing, so I didn't really look too much into it. But then they spilled it and they made a big old mess of it. And then they came back and said, hey, do you have paper towels in here? We need to clean this up now, please. And I was like, okay, let me get you something and we can clean this up together. No problem. I can help you take care of these. And then he started like to really fucking rush me about it. And I was like, I was in the back kitchen. I had to take off all my gloves. I had to put my knife down, make sure the fruit wasn't going to fall on the floor or anything. And he was just being a little bitch baby about it. I'm sure that everybody else at like the front has had worse Karen stories, but that's like the worst that I got in my back department. Mainly it was just my bitch of a boss who probably could have been a Karen himself.
Bosses absolutely can be.
Yeah, they can be. And he was just a dill hole. Whatever. That's not important. What about you, Ben? Have you had any Karens come? What was that noise? If we get another fucking meteor, I swear to God. Oh my God. Oh my
Is
God.
Is that a meteor?
That's a meteor.
That's a meteor.
That's a meteor. Oh, hello, Goo! What the fuck? Where? Why? Have we had at least one meteor every mission tonight?
Yeah, either the big ones or the small ones.
Oh my fucking God.
Looks like we got a big one.
Alright, well, do we want to do this now, or do we want to do this when we're done with the drill?
Let's just get rid of it now.
Alright, let's do this.
I'll put my turrets over by Doretta, so...
Okay.
Just in case anything comes towards her.
Sounds good. Okay.
The cave has been lit. Now we can really excavate this place.
All right. What about you, Ben? Have you had any or witnessed any particular Karens that have been very bad?
Fortunately, I haven't encountered many in a while, but I do remember some I saw when I was still in Boy Scouts.
Mm-hmm. Oh God, Boy Scouts!
Imagine a Karen on a camping trip.
Uh-huh.
They don't have all their amenities because you're on a camping trip. Or if you're on like a campground, they're not gonna give you those amenities because those are like emergency supplies.
What kind of amenities are we talking about? Like, what were they demanding?
Well, it's like, you know, it's been a while, so I'm like having to. I haven't talked about this in like forever because
you're all good. It's
been a while, but it's like
we can kind of assume like camping, emergency supplies, that sort of situation.
You know, complaining about like the tents.
Mm-hmm.
They're not comfortable enough, or something like that. Like you brought the supplies. You were told to bring what you needed.
You brought the tents. You brought the sleeping bags.
Like that. Stuff like that, where it's like, you were told to bring what you needed. It's not anyone else's fault here if something you want isn't here.
Yeah.
Or just like helicopter parents. That was one I despised.
I remember a bit of that.
That sounds about right. I could see that being a thing for the scouts.
Or it's like,
my precious baby.
Your precious baby. Like,
your precious baby is a little bitch.
Or worse, now that I remember, worse is when one of these Karens is one of your like scoutmasters or managers. Who has to micromanage every fucking action.
Was that Kathy?
Kathy.
Kathy?
You remember her.
I vaguely, yeah, Kathy. Because we were quote-unquote family friends with them.
Until she was an absolute bitch to our mom and then weren't.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, I was never really friends with her kids.
I think I might actually know who you're talking about, because I think we briefly talked about it before. I think I know. Yeah, okay,
Kathy,
I know.
Kathy, what the fuck was her name?
I liked one of the kids.
Which one? It was the oldest one, right? Yeah, the oldest. He was chill.
The oldest one was chill. The youngest was just a a dick, and the middle child was like her and had to micromanage fucking everything.
Matthew?
He was a nightmare to deal with.
Yeah. Matthew, yes!
Yep, yep. I know exactly who you're talking about.
What was the nightmare at the last, like, camp, summer camp thing I went to. It'd be like, for the most minor of shit, he would call everyone to assemble.
Oh, God.
And, like, would stall it up for 20, he would stall us going to, like, to lunch or whatever for 20 minutes because we didn't all exactly get into, like, perfect formation.
He was confident, like, Boy Scouts, not the fucking military.
It got to the point where, like, the Scoutmaster was just like,
yo, chill the fuck out.
Where the Scoutmaster, like, directly intervened and, like, no, we're going.
I'm so glad I knew.
He's like, and keep in mind, the Scoutmaster is like a 70-year-old like man. Like, he's and he has a lot of patience for bullshit. But like, you have to do a lot to actually make him get like that.
Yeah. Got a warden and, behind us somewhere. There it is.
Oh fuck.
They're a good way. So we're
here.
Good.
I'm just gonna throw this at the entrance.
You're going a satchel charge.
Blam him when he walks over it.
Got some gunk seeds coming down in this room. Nice.
Nice.
Good shit.
Another satchel charge going out. Another one.
Oh my god, how many do you have?
Four.
Oh my god, I see you opted for multiple rather than... I like it. Let me see. Fern had an answer for... worst Karen behavior. He said, I still can't get over the you don't sell salad, you sell bowls. But the worst Karen I ever dealt with has to be my mother. My mom once complained to a Trader Joe's manager because she saw two employees talking to each other while they were putting stuff away on the shelves. To quote, it is unprofessional to be talking in front of the customers.
Oh my
god. What?
Yes. That.
But they were working! Like,
Fern's quote-unquote mother is a piece of shit human being.
In the rare encounters I had with that person, none of them were pleasant.
No, because they're an unpleasant person.
Yeah.
From what they are an amalgamation of garbage in a flesh suit.
Garbage in a flesh suit. Sometimes I feel like garbage in a flesh suit.
No, Jonah, you're more of garbage with some
Febreze. Garbage with what, Kieran?
Febreze.
Ah, so if blindfolded people walk by me, they're like, oh, it's fine.
Oh, this smells nice. It smells vaguely of, like, cinnamon.
And then they see me, they're like, what the fuck is that? Oh, boy. What about you, Kieran? I know where you worked, so I'm sure you have some Karen stories to tell.
Oh, you get your fair share. I've already regaled with, like, a lot of the classics, you know, the candy store receipt, the various individual, the woman who had asked if we had a gazebo in a small in-mall retail store that definitely could not house a gazebo, much less sell one. to all your staple classics. I still think the personal one that rubbed me the wrongest way, because there are some Karen behaviors that when they happen, I kind of slightly get where some of them are coming from. I am like, okay, I think I see the vague idea of what your complaint is. I don't agree with it. I think you're being irrational and angry, but I understand this, and this individual came in and I did not quite understand. A group of five ladies came in during our favorite year, 2020.
A good year!
The year!
Almost as old as I am!
It's gonna be one of those stories, yeah. And they come in, none of them wearing any facial covering, and we very calmly, diplomatically ask that they should all wear facial covering. Their exact reason why all five of them didn't is, quote, one of them has a medical condition.
Oh boy, real original. Haven't heard that one before.
To me, the most baffling thing was just like, okay, let's assume in a reality where that is acceptable, it isn't. How does that stop the other four of you from doing it?
It's our medical condition here.
Well, this was like, again, during that dreaded year where I was very much like on my last bit of sass to give. So I basically directly asked them, like, how does that stop the other four of you? To which one of the other four chimed in, we're doing it out of solidarity.
Oh my god.
Solidarity, get fucked.
And I was just like, oh, well, I hope you will understand the solidarity I share with my coworkers when I ask you to get the fuck out of the store.
Face.
I wish I could tell people to leave.
We all do, Zach. But we all do.
If this was a just world, every retail person would be allowed to kill a customer.
Can someone clip that, please? We need to know if this ever
runs
becomes...
for president. His platform is retail workers will be allowed to murder.
Retail workers get one customer per year. Where they can murder, no questions asked, and no charges will be pressed. Oh my god.
I mean, my favorite is when people come in, like, because we do notary stuff at our UPS store.
Yeah.
I'm a public notary through the UPS.
And public notaries.
Yeah. Our hours end at 5 for public notary. 5 p.m. I've had so many, particularly one woman who came at like 5:15, like, we need something notarized. Well, our notary hours ended at 5. It's 5:15, really? Yes, it was 5:15. We're just 15 minutes after 5.
Thank you, John.
I'm not notarizing that.
Yeah.
Or when they ask me to just do something, like, illegal. Like, I know none of the people on this document are here to sign it with their IDs, but can you just notarize it anyway?
Retail employees get one free murder. Someday. Someone clip it, so if it ever becomes a thing, we own a piece of history on this channel. All right, I'm sending the...
The purge, but it's exclusively for retail workers.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, obviously, that's what they
do. For 24 hours, all retail workers getting their justice is legal.
Be afraid to go into a retail store. I'm sorry, you really want that handbag? How badly do you want to behave for that handbag?
Can I have this notarized? No, fuck off.
Fruit Sushi says, lol, I worked register at Fred Meyer like 2 days ago. I made an old man so mad he complained about me twice.
Amazing.
Just another day
in retail.
I've had
people complain about me.
I'm sure people have complained about me before.
Look, see, I will bend the rules about things if you are nice.
Yeah.
Like, if you're nice and desperate and like, oh, I just need to have this thing done, and you're polite about it, I will bend the rules. I'll break them even.
Yeah.
If you're an asshole about it, no, fuck you, I am following the letter of the law and nothing else.
You know the rules, and so do I.
So, goodbye.
Here's the thing, Karens. Take note, if you're ever watching my channel for some reason, first off, reevaluate your behavior. Second off, treat people nicely. It might actually help you out.
And then we see on Karen Twitter, right.
Local streamer encourages people to literally change their behavior, literally 1984.
I will say...
Thank you, Zach.
There's a particular meme that I was finding very appropriate, which is like... It's the sentiment that, you know, no one has felt the desire to be more cooperative because you were yelling.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly. Yelling at someone is not going to make your situation better. It's going to make it worse. This is a interesting place for a supply pod.
The only thing yelling will accomplish is Zach? Either make an Zach? Already easy process stressful or an impossible process to
that's a wonderful spot.
Well, you get maybe three ticks out of it, so...
It's really accessible.
Oh, you know what's even better? People are voting in chat for supplies for the crew right now, so I'm going to stand back just a little bit. And that'll come in here. That'll come in here soon. Gamma said, bruh, the pod just slipped. All right. Very nice. Well, I'm glad we at least had a pretty good amount of Karen stories, so...
Yeah, I think the worst of mine have usually been the notaries, and just like, what do you mean you can't notarize it? I didn't see you fucking sign it, ma'am.
I still will think,
that's the whole point, is to watch you sign it.
The thing I love about a financial institution that is entirely based is the fact that when we have to close, we full on close. It's not a you get to come in at the last minute or something. It's a we are close. Go home.
Oh god, yeah, that's such an issue with us.
And so a person will come in 5 minutes before close and say, I need to do this 50-minute process. And we'll say, oh, we can't do that. Our systems are shutting down for that.
Yep.
And they're responsible to explain to them very much why we can't do this today. They look at me and say, so what are we going to do? I'm like, oh, you assume there's a we in there. It's a you.
this is a you problem.
You
can come in tomorrow.
When I've had people argue with me about when my store closes.
Oh, dear.
Oh, God!
Google says it's 7 p.m. You're looking at a store in Greenwood, ma'am. We are in Ballard.
We got rocks.
Can you smell what the rock is cooking?
Can you smell what the rock is?
I have been asked to notarize a fair share of bizarre things that don't really accomplish anything. I recently just got asked to notarize a piece of notepad paper.
Notepad paper?
Technically speaking, you can pretty much notarize any statement.
Can you? Okay.
As long as there's verbiage for it.
I know we've explained this process before. Can you explain me the process of notarizing? Like, what is it? What is it for? Remind me again.
So, a notary certification is basically attesting through some public officer who is affiliated with the government in some small capacity that one of like three are the most common forms of notary that you'll see. First most common is acknowledgement. I am acknowledging that this is Jonah's signature on this piece of paper,
okay,
and that it matches the one in my notary. The second is a sworn notary. I am acknowledging that I did hear Jonah swear that he would only eat green beans on Wednesdays.
Well,
and I
eat him. Get the bag.
And the third most common is the certified copy, where basically like, hey. In lieu of the fact that, you know, like, a death certificate is hard and you can't just, like, make copies of it, this certified copy means that I did see the original death certificate. It was real. It was valid. This is a copy of this, so you can trust that this wasn't just manufactured. Those are the three most common kinds of notes. It is worth noting that when I acknowledge your signature, when I am acknowledging your sworn oath, neither of those instances am I acknowledging what the oath is or that what you're signing is true. I am just acknowledging that, yes, that was Jonah's signature.
That you signed it.
What Jonah is agreeing to, I have no sway or authority.
And it's basically, you are putting your little stamp there saying, I saw them do this at this time, at this place.
Yeah. All right, now, then we got crystals. Can you drill those out for us?
Yep, cover me.
Yep, got you.
Now again, there's exceptions to the process. Obviously, there will be some notaries that are a little bit different than others. But typically, that's what you usually say. The big type of notary that we can't do, usually in my financial institution, Zach, you might have a similar policy, is there used to be these notary documents that asked if you were of sound mind when you were doing it.
I haven't had any of those come in.
It's basically to, like, say, hey, the person who is signing this document is of a sound mind, and you as a notary are attesting that they are of a sound mind. Here's the thing. Notaries are, by and large, encouraged not to do those anymore, because none of us are medical professionals. You can't make that attestation.
Yeah.
We also recently had an update where we can't notarize any documents that talk about being sovereign citizens or anything. because that was a whole ordeal.
Yeah.
But basically, yes. And here's the big thing about being a notary. I'm not attesting how to do another company's policy. Like, if the government says, hey, can you notarize this document, like this vehicle title application, and the customer asks me, hey, Kieran, do you think this is the way they want it filled out? I answer. The legal answer I am supposed to give, and I will always give, is I don't know.
Yep.
Because I don't know how they want you to fill it out. That's for you to tell me. I don't get to just know. And here's the simple truth. 9 times out of 10, I have a reasonable guess, but it's...
You're not allowed to say it.
Yeah. And one of the things that our little arbitration waiver states is, like, we're not legal professionals. We can't give you legal advice. Don't say we gave you legal advice.
For legal reasons, I don't know. For legal reasons, I don't know.
Yes.
Do we just need to call the pod now?
Pretty much. We rolled the shiny into the thing.
We do need gunk seeds, but I think we're chilling to get out of here, aren't we?
I don't care about gunk seeds.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
Where is she?
We're out. We're outy.
Okay, but where's Dorit?
I got Dottie. I got Dottie.
Okay, you got Dottie.
Let's go.
It's cold down here. Basically, with those parameters, a person can put anything they want on the document, and so long as the notary verbiage doesn't ask me to agree to something that I physically can't, I'll notarize it and ease it. Now, PECU and some other financial institutions have a few stamps that they can provide as notary verbiage.
My store's got a similar thing.
In lieu of documents just missing them, and they're like, well, I needed to do this, but they didn't include the verbiage for some reason. We're like, no problem, we can include this verbiage, because that's something we can reasonably agree to. I remember calling our support network, because a person wanted me to notarize a piece of paper that basically attested that another person was paying them $500 a month in child support.
The fuck? Sorry. Yeah.
No, this was not a government official document. This was them literally ripping off a piece of our notepad paper and writing down, my husband pays $500 a month in support of our child.
Okay.
And it wasn't even specifically $500. They said anywhere between $350 to $500. I'm like,
I got you, soldier. Eight
pieces. Perfect. And I called our support network and asked, hey, is this technically legal for me to notarize? And they were very confused. They're like, why would you want to notarize? This makes no sense. This won't do anything. It's like...
It's not proof of anything.
It's a worthless piece of paper. And I caveated because the customer was insistent. I understand that, sir. But the question wasn't whether or not it's effective. The question is, can I do it?
Yeah.
And legally, am I allowed to do this?
And he responded with, technically yes, but why? And I'm like, because some people are crazy, man.
It's true.
And so I get the go-ahead. I look at the lady very calmly, and I'm just like, yeah, go for it. And she was asking me at the end, and she's like, do you think this will work? And I'm like, I cannot give you legal advice, man. I don't know.
What I can say is that is a fantastic question.
Just like, that is a piece of paper.
It's true. Yeah. Man, we initially started with Karens and we went full on with like notaries and what they do.
Yep. I mean, I get a lot of Karens with notary things. Especially with, what do you mean you can't be a witness? Ma'am, I'm notarizing it.
I'm notarizing it. I'm looking at the paper and saying, yep.
I can't also be a witness.
So, that's another big
thing. No, my coworkers can't be them either. You need to provide those.
I'll be right back, but keep talking. I'm still listening.
That's another thing about big notaries is that when it comes to witness signatures, the company that is notarizing your documents cannot also be witnesses for said documents.
Yes.
There's an innate conflict of interest. Now, here's the funny thing, and I don't know if your company is allowed to do this, Zach, but I know we are passively not. not encouraged to do this, but it's not, like, prohibited. If another customer comes walking inside the store, that can be a witness. They don't have to know the person.
Yes, to be a witness. Technically speaking, I believe, but we strongly discourage it. Mm-hmm. I believe Rita's told me don't let them do that.
Mm-hmm. But it is technically correct, which is the best card currently. There's no official parameters for verification of a witness beyond just, do they have an ID? Fantastic, that's all I need.
Huzzah! Yep.
Did you meet them on the street 5 seconds ago? That works just fine. We used to have customers do that all the freaking time, where they would go, like, one cubicle over and say, hey man, can you be a great for witness for
me? Can you be a witness for me?
And they were like, oh yeah, sure man, I got you.
The other big problem is people bringing in things that have already been signed.
Yep, no.
What do you mean? Can't you just sign it? What if I cross it out? No, ma'am, that's not how it works. You're just gonna want to go print out a new one.
I also enjoy being a notary because it's one of the few things where I can directly just, like, this isn't... I don't know if this is a caveat for your business, Zach. I hope it is, because it's amazing for mine. It's the... We as notaries reserve the right to refuse to notarize a document if we feel uncomfortable.
I believe I technically can.
Even if everything is all sorted out, if the person is being pushy or being difficult, it is one of the few times we are allowed to say, sir, I'm not going to notarize this document.
Second chat.
And I distinctly remember when a member came in with a document that had no notary verbiage. Okay. And I offered to put some verbiage on there from our company. He said, no, I will go home and get some proper verbiage, and then you will notarize it, right? And I said, well, I don't know, sir. I would have to see what that verbiage says. And he's like, if I do this, can you notarize it? Yes or no? And I'm like, depends on what it says, sir. They kept pushing, just saying that yes or no, yes or no, can you do this? And then after the fourth time of him, like, cutting me off, because he was, like, you're talking, and just, yes or no, I'm like, well, sir, at this point, no, I'm not going to notarize your document.
Aha! Fucking got him. Can't wait to
show perks of being a licensed officer. But honestly, from what I hear outside of it, being a notary is a pretty decently lucrative profession.
And to my knowledge, yeah, the store just charges $10 and I don't get paid the $10.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Not right into your pockets.
I don't get commission.
That's bullshit.
Although one of my coworkers did briefly, because he did it after the hours we were supposed to do it.
Oh, well, that's...
It was like, it's 5:10. Whatever, just give me the $10 and I'll do it.
Yeah. Okay. That's cool.
Yeah.
Just bang it out real quick.
If I were to ever leave the ECU, I still have my notary license for a few years after that, so I can still be employed as a notary public for the state of Washington.
Nice.
And, yeah. It's a little feeling. There's always inherent risks. You have to be very careful with how you read the documents and how you verify and address people.
Because your ass is on the line if something goes wrong.
But also at the same time, you're like, when things like, if you get everything sorted out, the worst they can say is, yes, this person did witness my signature.
And usually in my experience, it's, something was done wrong on this. This isn't valid. Go do it again.
Yes.
Rather than, oh, time for lawsuit!
Yeah. Ooh, ow.
Have you thought about not doing that?
I have thought. Can't say about that.
Anyway. I'm sorry, guys. That didn't start much of a fight. That's fine with us.
I mean, it caused discussion, so you know what? It's all good. I enjoyed it. Who's up next?
Okay, random pet peeve about shipping is when someone comes in asking for a box. I'm like, what size do you need? And they just go, oh, I need something about big, and just hold their hands out. I'm like, sir, I need measurements.
we yeah, big is only gonna get you so far.
Or like, I want to ship something. Okay, where what are the dimensions? Oh, you know, it's like hands, sir. I need numbers.
Yep.
How heavy is it? Oh, it's kind of heavy. Can you give me a weight?
If you had to pick one person, either in your friend group or outside in a friend group, even if it's someone you don't know, who would you want as your personal life coach or motivator? You had to have someone.
Anyone? Anyone at all?
Yes.
Morgan Freeman. Full stop.
I mean, fucking valid.
I will refuse to elaborate. I feel like I don't need to.
There is no elaboration needed.
Yeah. There you go. That is my choice. Ooh! We got a natty Crassus.
Ooh.
And we're rich.
Jumping off of that, my brain went to Keith David.
We all need a wise, deep voice black man in our lives. It just helps you get through whatever you need to get through. You know?
The disrespect towards this NBL Jackson. Come now.
Hey, man!
I don't need wise and deep. I need loud and angry.
You need someone like tell Danny you. Trejo. You need someone tell you, motherfucker.
The fact that he has still not been given the.
Oh God! Not again! No! Get away from that! Faster, please! Because, like, how old is he now? Isn't he like in his 70s?
Yeah.
Damn. That's crazy. All right, so far,
okay, either Keith David or Danny Trejo, because that'd also be awesome.
Danny Trejo. All right.
Honestly, Danny Trejo. Now that I think about it,
I'm sticking with Morgan Freeman. What about you, Ben? God. If you had a personal, anyone you could pick as your life coach, who would it be? Oh fuck.
I've been thinking, and like, I'm still not sure.
I'm throwing it on fire.
Can it be a fictional character?
Oh.
I will say, since I'm asking this question, no, it has to be someone within our universe.
Within our own universe. There's a nice pit of just fester flea garbage down there.
We're going to avoid that place.
Yep. I already took care of it. Uh-oh. We're good.
What about that shadowy place?
That shadowy... No, Sippa. That is the Festerfully pit. We never go there. Well, fortunately for you guys, there's a shit ton of red sugar in here, so help yourself.
Time to create an abomination.
All right. Well, do you have an answer, Ben, or are you going to take time to think about that?
I'm, like, still thinking about it.
Okay.
I'm just...
Oh, good. Let me see. How's Chad doing? Gamma says, Jonah, what's your opinion on the Sniper Elite series? I don't think I've ever played any of them.
Sniper Eliter.
Sniper Eliter. So I can't really give an opinion on that.
Sniper Eliter.
Sniper Eliter.
Sniper a ruler.
Sniper a ruler. Sniper arugula. God damn it.
It is a spice.
See, we have more Karen talk from Fruit Sushi. This is why I should have never joined this crap email site. Patrick, first of all, this is not an email site. Get your facts straight or I will sue you. Damn.
Your lack of factual upbringing demand lawsuit and litigation.
I find your lack of factual evidence disturbing.
Hello, Ben.
Hi.
All right.
Do you have an issue with what I'm building?
No.
I'm gonna take that as a
I got him.
What happened? Red. What happened? Oh. Well, while Ben takes time to think, if Ben comes up with an answer, I would like to vote for the next question to be deep. Give us a deep question.
I actually had a small injury.
What happened?
I used Ironwood to get you back up.
Oh.
I'm also mining out that gold pit, Kieran, that we were working on before. Oh boy. Let me see.
Zach?
Yeah?
Swarm.
Yeah. Somewhere. I don't.
Shawarma. Never had shawarma.
I am unconcerned. I am building my abomination pipe.
Zach's got his priorities straight.
My priorities are making a problem.
I think we have a bulk somewhere.
We definitely do. That was a bulk.
Yep, there it is.
Light it up!
Did you remember to bring hyper propellant, Zach? Or are you still?
Oh, I brought the laser.
Oh. Oh shit. Oh god. Oh. My shield had the best timing. Thank you for the bubble fern. Oh. Ow. There you go, Kieran.
Fuck. Try jaw.
Did it build into the okay. Okay, oppressor. Okay, oppressor. Okay, oppressor.
Oh, fuck.
You wanna talk? Let's talk, motherfucker!
Oh, shit. Shit. Fuck. Cock.
Oh, boy.
Hi, Kieran.
I'm coming, boy. Oh. Hold on a second. Something ain't right here. What the fuck is going on down here?
Don't worry about it.
God damn it.
Don't criticize my creations.
I'm not criticizing, I'm questioning what's happening with it.
Don't question it. He's special.
It's special, all right. Ow.
I slept because I was busy shooting something.
This next question just says, marry, fuck, kill.
Oh, marry, no. Fuck, kill? Anybody. Oh, no. Okay, I think because you're the one ask. Okay, give us a marry, fuck, kill, Kieran. Come on.
Keanu Reeves.
Okay.
Pedro Pascal.
Okay.
And Tom Kenny.
Oh, no. Okay.
And who?
Tom Kenny, the voice of SpongeBob.
Ah.
SpongeBob, Eduardo... the mayor from Powerpuff Girls, also the narrator of the Powerpuff Girls, and a shit ton of other voices. He's all over the industry. Let's see. This is open to anybody who can answer first, right, Kieran?
Yeah, it's open to anyone who has strong opinions on the Mary
Pop Kill. Oh, I don't say this lightly. I'm just gonna open up with Kill Tom Kenny. I hate that I'm saying that. But that's
man wants to kill Tom Kenny. You heard it here.
You heard it here first, folks.
Get Ow. The call out first.
Mary
canceled.
Oh God, it's a tough pick between those two. I'd have to say Mary Keanu, and fuck Pedro Pascal.
I think that's just objectively the correct option.
Yeah.
At a minimum, you're fucking Pedro Pascal.
Yeah, at the minimum, Pedro Pascal is the one getting fucked. Like, you could... They're, like... It's tough with the kill one, because they're all so great, but, like... It's Pedro Pascal for fucking. You know he's a good smash. So there you go.
I think I'm killing Keanu Reeves, and I'm married to Top Kenny.
Yeah, I could see that. Yeah. I love that it's just marry, fuck, kill. Which
okay,
one was that one?
That the pipeline I was going for has been
this was
taken.
The tame category. I guess because it's really up to the individual deciding it on like how intense it gets.
That's true. That's fair. You know what? You can make it as deep as you want to, just as much as you can make
Ben,
it.
Ben, could I get some drilling expertise over here? While you're floating?
I'm trying to finish your pipe.
Well, I haven't finished it yet, is why I need the driller expertise.
Francis, Keanu Reeves would make a wonderful husband, in my opinion. Absolutely.
By the time I'm finished building, you could probably just go through whatever you're trying to go through.
It's making it worse!
You know what? That's great.
He's just taking over my pipe!
I feel like we're all pretty much in agreement on that question. Oh,
he's
God.
He's taking over my pipeline. Look at him go.
What the fuck is happening down here? Oh, God. Okay. Oh, dear. Oh, no.
Because the pump jack I have to get to is over there.
I think drilling expertise might be needed here.
Yeah,
oh, no.
I think...
Okay, fine.
See, now we're just looping in a circle, Kieran.
No,
can't...
and this will fuck up the grinding. Kieran, no.
No. This deconstruct. Deconstruct. No!
Kieran, you fucked up the grinding. No!
God, where does it end?
You guys know how to dig holes.
No!
We need to go this
get
way.
It. Get it quick! Get it! Someone get it! No!
Kieran! Okay.
Kill him. Fuck's sake. Okay.
Not my dreams.
No, Kieran.
Kieran. Your dreams fucked up the grinding.
Can we at least start back from square one? Okay. That's it. I didn't want to do that.
Yeah, mercilessly
kill. Listen, I think after all the fucking times I've gotten murked on this fucking show, I think I can earn one.
I will kill the dog's life.
All right, we can start from this point, Kieran. Here. This is fine. We can still work with this. Zach, do you want me to res him or do you want to keep working?
Let's keep working. Okay, I need it to go this way.
Okay, you take control of that. I'll give you a bit to get that. I'll get him up in a second. I'm going to grab that fossil up there.
Okay. Here is a way to start off a fight. Who is the correct choice in Mario Kart?
Depends on the game.
Who is the correct choice in Mario Kart?
Okay. Can I posit an answer? Anyone but Mario.
Yes, yes. Literally anyone but Mario. If you pick Mario in Mario Kart, I'm going to tell you right now, chat, if you look me in the eye right now, look at me. I know you're not looking. Look at me right now. If you pick Mario, you're basic. Like... Not even. Oh God, what is this? Bertucci says bad and naughty Kieran's go to the infested pit. Who is the correct choice for me?
I always picked Shy Guy when he was an option.
I always picked King Boo. Yeah. See, but this is about our personal. Yeah, so it's gonna be okay. Here we go. I always liked having a heavy character because having a heavier character was easier to control. And you could build up a lot of momentum with that. So personally, I like any one of the heavies. And they always go back and forth on who gets like what amount of love depending on what game you're playing. Like some games it'll be the lighter characters that are getting more love and they're just objectively the better choice. Some games it's the heavier characters. But I always just like big characters.
Now you all have very fair answers.
All right, Kieran, say the one that's going to start the fight. I'm ready.
What? I mean, half the heavy disagree on King Boo.
No. Sorry. Cringe.
It's just not really.
Fuck you. Ghost is awesome. Ghost based. My parents would always go back and forth between Toad and Yoshi. That was their main picks.
But there is only one correct answer.
If you say fucking Cat Mario, I know where you live.
Bulk!
Bulk!
I mean, I think Mario is a fair, respectable option. Definitely better than King Boo, sir.
Okay. Oh,
no!
Okay.
Okay. Mario is objectively the incorrect answer.
You're allowed to, you can disagree with me all you want on fucking King Boo, whether or not it's the must pick. But if you put Mario over King Boo, no, we're not doing that. No, fuck off with that bullshit.
Oh, you put Mario. He is the OG. The franchise does not fucking exist without the king.
And when you have literally every other character in the game, Karen, you have so many options. Mario is the human fighter of Mario Kart and Smash. There, I said it.
And there's a reason why everyone fucking plays.
I respect picking Mario in Smash more than picking Mario in Mario Kart.
You just have so many options. Ooh!
But I will say Mario is not the, like, 100% correct choice. He is a solid third place at best.
Third place? Okay. What's your Mario Kart tier list, Kieran? Oh, there's the bulk.
We only have King Boo at the very bottom.
Okay, fuck off. Incorrect.
Next to any of, like, those, like, me characters. Like,
yeah, no, me characters are F tier. Boo is C. King Boo is C at worst, and you know it.
I think you're being generous and trying to pass off a D as a C.
No, fuck you, Karen. I'll agree with you on the me's.
He's asking for, you know, some rounding up on that grade.
Can we up that bell curve a little bit? Jesus, Teach.
I'm sorry, but you have a ghost of a chance of improving that grade.
Oh, fuck! Okay. No, I did walk into that one, but... Boo this man.
Can you help me, Ben?
Where? What?
I need you to drill a hole in this direction.
Second
where?
I think...
Right behind. Right.
You need to point it out, because there's so much fucking shit in
right here.
On the
I just need you to drill towards the pump jack, so that direction right there.
The second place has to honestly go to Luigi, because poor guy. Honestly,
Luigi is more valid than Mario. Yes.
Yeah, Luigi is more valid. Are you putting Mario? You're seriously putting Mario at top tier? You're putting Mario that high up?
Third place.
Okay, so third place Mario, second Luigi. Okay, I'll give you Luigi. I won't give you Mario.
First is Shy Guy, obviously.
Nope.
First is the correct choice. Wow. Luigi.
Okay, you know what?
That's a valid answer.
I will give you that.
Thank you.
I will fight you all day on King Boo, because I love my boy. Luigi's Mansion has and always will be my favorite Mario game.
We need to see the beauty of this creation, Ben.
I think there is a point. Fern, no, you're wrong too. Fern's wrong too. Clearly, the superior choice is Rose Gold Peach. Rose Gold Peach? Metal Peach?
God damn it, the grinding's fucked up.
Is it already connected?
Yeah.
What's fucked up with it? Is it hitting a pipe?
Yeah, I'm running into a pipe, at least grinding back. I don't know about grinding too.
Let me see.
In a similar vein, since we
were it's just fucked.
It's only natural we talked about another property of the same thing.
Oh no. Oh no.
Smash Brothers.
Oh god. Okay. Before we do that, which game? Because there's so much.
There is truly so much. To offer the most wide variety and to allow for people of both the new and the old generations to feel respected.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot in good conscience do Brawl. I love Brawl, don't get me wrong. It introduced a lot of things, but it was broken as fuck and skewed towards a very few select cast of characters.
I mean, Melee did the same thing, too. Like,
Melee absolutely did. And the original holds a special place in my personal heart, because that was my first game.
Like, the N64?
Yeah.
Ooh!
Mm-hmm. Yes. Where I mained Aimed, who at the time was in my top choice, but now is still in my top five, is the Captain Falcon.
Yeah. Show your moves!
Which is so sad, considering he's, like, almost never had a game made after that.
I mean, there was F-Zero GX, but that's pretty much it. We do need another F-Zero game at some point.
But yes, consider the most recent iteration.
I'm starting it up. Okay, so Smash Ultimate. We're considering Smash Ultimate. Oh boy.
With three caveats for this.
Okay.
First, what is the most fun and satisfying for you to play?
I have a good answer for that.
Oh boy. Okay. So, what is the most satisfying and fun for you to play? What other caveats do we have?
The second caveat is what about them makes them satisfying to play?
So, who's your main? Why do you main them?
Okay.
And number three, what is the most bullshit strategy you pulled off?
Just as a note, Ben, this is for Smash characters.
I heard something completely different. I can't hear shit right now. There's so many fucking things exploding.
I thought you would just fucking say TF2 to be that guy.
Someday we'll get Team Fortress in Smash. Okay. Are we including DLC characters? Because there have been a few that have come out that I particularly enjoy.
I'm gonna say in the interest of keeping it simple, no.
Okay, so vanilla Smash Ultimate. Alright. That's fine. Okay. Before I answer this, Fruit Sushi says on the topic of Mario Kart, incorrect. The true choice is it doesn't matter because the point of playing Mario Kart is to sit in last place and blue shell the people actually taking it seriously. Based.
I'm not here to win. I'm not even here to have fun. I'm here to ruin your fun.
It's not about winning. It's about sending a message. I think we've talked about our Smash mains before, but it's been a while. Okay, so base game, Smash Ultimate. I would have to say, can we pick, is it one character that we exclusively play?
Two
characters? Okay. I would have to, ooh. Okay, no, I can answer this one. For me, it's a toss-up between number one, King K. Rool.
Is not surprising in the slightest.
I mean, wait till you hear my next one, what? Zach. I bet you won't even be able to get
it. Is it a Bowser?
King Dedede, actually.
You know, that tracks.
But for King K. Rool, like, when King K. Rool was first announced, that was one of the characters that was in the community being hyped up for the longest time, right? It was King K. Rool, Ridley, and Banjo-Kazooie. They were like, those are like, and from what I've seen, the top three characters that were requested for Smash. And when they made it in there, everybody fucking exploded. But in terms of mechanics, King K. Rool is a big heavy, right? So you already know I love my thick boys. But he's so heavy to the point where even if you get him to like 300% damage, you cannot knock him off the fucking stage. Like, if a good King K. Rool knows what they're doing, you will not throw them off. And the fact that they have the stupid reflection ability or whatever through the stomach, his golden belly, it's so busted. It's so good. And just the amount of combos that you can do with his suck gun is like one of the most fun bits of playing a character that I've ever had. And also just the satisfying reverse air that you can get with just smashing people downward. The spikes I've seen done with that are insane. And as for King Dedede, similar vibe, but they have the floating ability that Kirby has. And just that hammer, when you get somebody with that, either through a smash or through like charging it up with your down B, it feels almost as good as getting a Falcon Punch off. It is,
ooh, it's so satisfying.
That's what I got on that.
Keyword being almost.
Almost. I will not deny that when you get a Falcon Punch off, it is, ooh, it's so good. Or just like a Falcon Punch-like ability. It's so good. Now it's fucking raining. All right, but that's my piece. I've blathered on long enough about it.
Passing it over to Mr. Zach. Pipeline functional
You got a main, buddy?
For Ultimate?
Yeah.
I believe when I played it, when we had it, I mostly played Richter Belmont.
I could see that.
That feels so Zach.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about you all just saying that makes sense. Why does this make sense? Explain.
I don't know. It just feels right, you know?
You know, Zach, you must be the Belmont.
It's like good porn. You can't describe it, but you know it when you see it.
My God.
Obviously, this man has never read an erotic novel, but you know.
But yeah, mostly I played Richter Belmont.
Why not Simon, if I may ask?
Mostly because I unlocked Richter first.
Okay. Interesting.
And I'm like, why would I play the same character but different?
If you had to pick a secondary character.
Fox.
I could... Yeah.
That one I see a little bit less, but I do understand it.
I
Fox, because I played him the most when I played Melee.
I understand. Similar vein. I understand that more. Yeah, because Fox is just good.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm going to make Guanju particularly happy.
Oh.
But the first choice, undisputed, Mr. Game & Watch.
My man! I like Game & Watch just to meme on people.
Look, nothing's more satisfying than kicking someone's ass with a two-dimensional character.
When you hit that 9 off with the hammer, dude, oh my God, you can't come back from that. Their career is over at that point.
Yeah. No, but,
I can't fucking see shit in here.
Richter Belmont is as on point for you as is, like, Eden saying something like Pokemon.
Huh.
Which is interesting, because Eden, I believe, and if Eden's still here in chat, she can correct me, but she likes to main Palutena and Link, which makes more sense, but still.
I was half expecting you to say, like, fucking Pichu.
I think she's done a little bit of action.
I was
going to
say
Pichu.
Eden's a war criminal.
But my personal favorite, and it's less for like practical reasons or even like winning reasons, but I have a lot of fun playing him. He is Captain Obvious. I do enjoy my Pikmin.
Yeah.
It's a nostalgic video game for myself. And when they announced that he was going to be in Brawl, I was way too excited. Everyone else was just like, oh, who the fuck is this guy? I was like, it's Captain Oliver! He's got the
pick! Alright, if you need to make your way back, take pipeline 2, Kieran. I'll drop you off right next to it. Fern says, Kirby. Kirby is just so fun to play for me. First character I ever played Smash with. So bouncy and I can easily jump around. And my most bullshit move was eating someone and then jumping off the edge and spinning the other person into the abyss. That's what I did as King Dedede too! That's just how you do it, man.
I can't seem to find the exit.
Take pipeline number 2, Kieran.
I'm on pipeline number 2. I keep going in circles.
You're gonna be there for a minute. Just keep riding. Just don't stop.
No, I will absolutely stop. Fuck that shit.
Well, we tried. Yeah, you're on the right track. You're good. All right. What about you, Ben? Do you have a main in Smash? Ben?
Oh, I was muted.
Okay.
I've never really been much of a person to play Smash, but
yeah.
I've always enjoyed Samus.
Samus is good, yeah.
I don't know particularly why, that one just seems to click. That one just... She just clicked.
It just works. Get him.
Get his ass.
Why?
Hold on. I'm not out of ammo yet. Give me a second.
Extract his flesh.
I'm officially out. Hold on. I'm not out of ammo yet. Give me a second. Oh my God.
It's so fucking bright in here. Oh my god.
Wait, can we leave?
Kieran's the only one holding us up. Kieran's dumping his ammo right now. Hold on. I have officially dumped all my ammo. Wait, hold on a sec. Okay, now I've dumped all my ammo, including flares.
I can't damage him.
Because we're inside the pod.
But there's only a safe zone right there.
Nope, it's when you step in the pod. Oh, there you go. Yep. There you go. All right. Good show, gents.
There's this bullet casing sliding this pod. We can't back to mission control. They're like, what the fuck happened in there?
Don't worry about it. It's fine.
There are a bunch of glyphids get inside the pod. Yeah, glyphids.
Yes, glyphids. Don't mind the bullet holes that are in Engie's armor. It's fine. Oh my gosh. All right. Good stuff, everybody. Oh shit, and I got my performance stuff done. Nice. Got two things of creds.
Faces of performance. Oh!
Kill him.
Get him. Get his ass, boys.
Oh yeah, you and what army, punk?
Me and this. Rockety, rockin' stone. That's it.
Oh shit, I'm convinced.
Yeah. Prince, I felt so much pride when I pulled off that move. I was 16 and playing up against full adults. That's how you dunk on them. All right, well, it looks like Ben's about to DC, but we have reached the end of the night. Do you have one more question for us, Kieran, or are we good to wrap up there?
If you had to wear one outfit for the rest of your life, what would that outfit consist of?
Oh boy.
Assume for the context of this question, it is deemed work appropriate.
Work appropriate.
You can, of course, take it off to wash it, but when you get dressed in the morning, that is the only outfit you will ever put on for the rest of your life.
I'd have to say... Oh boy, a nice, like, thin t-shirt, like, whatever, it doesn't have to be, there's no particular design, but just something that I could wear both, like, in hot and cold weather, because I usually do pretty well with those, for the most part, but like a nice light color, like a white, maybe, I don't know, I want to be that asshole and say I want the pants that you can like zip off to make it like shorts or whatever, so I could be adaptable. And yeah, I'll bring my coat with me, my normal leather coat. So if it gets too chilly or if it gets too hot, I can just kind of throw that over. Yeah, a little basic except for the pants. And a nice hat. I don't know what kind of hat, but a nice hat. And fuck it. You know what? I'll make it extravagant. I want a fucking tricorn. If I'm going to wear that for the rest of my life, I'm wearing a goddamn tricorn. That's what I have to say about that. What about you guys?
I mean, it'd probably be a variation on the same shit I always wear, which is...
A blue hoodie, blue shirt, blue jeans.
Not just a blue hoodie.
Several blue hoodies used in ways they're not supposed to be.
Three blue hoodies and a trench coat.
with maybe some, like, quote-unquote black fur on the inside. A zipper that doesn't quite work.
Black fur on the inside. Not polyester, black fur.
God, no, I'd roast in that.
Man skinned a skunk to make the lining of his hoodie.
That skunk had it coming.
Yeah.
I'm going to be right back while Deep Rock
crashes.
Oh, yeah. It does that. It happens.
I'm praying it'll come back by the time I'll come back. But
You're good. We're wrapping up for the evening anyway, so you're all good, Ben.
All right, well, I'll be right back.
Okay, sounds good. Friend said, I don't have a job, so my work appropriate outfit would consist of booty shorts and thigh highs, a tank top underneath, an oversized hoodie, all in pastels. Nice.
Valid.
Honestly, let me get some booty shorts. Goddamn. I'll wear booty shorts. Fuck it. Especially nowadays. Fuck, it gets so hot over here. Goddamn. Ugh. We have no AC. It's cringe.
Yeah, fuck you, Ben, and your air conditioning.
Eden said, I came back at booty shorts?
I'm sorry, Eden Jones, you're only going to be wearing booty shorts for the foreseeable future.
Yes, we do have AC, but only in our room and the living room, Eden. We don't have it down here.
We live in Washington. AC is not a thing we have.
Not a built-in thing into our house. What about you, Kieran? What would be your fit for the rest of your life?
A pink suit jacket.
A pink suit jacket? Just a pink suit jacket?
Tell me there's more to the outfit than that.
Nah, just the pink suit jacket. He's going like half Saul Goodman, half naked Kieran.
It's something I've wanted since I was a wee boy. While we were in India, I was heavily discouraged from getting one cut tailor-made.
Oh my god, really?
Mm-hmm. I instead got a seafoam green suit jacket.
Okay. Next time, Kieran.
Okay, but what, like, shade of pink?
What type of pink?
Yeah, like what shade? Are we talking like a muted pink, vivid bubblegum pink?
Neon pink.
Okay, are we going to get pedantic up this? Because I will happily get it. We are talking Kieran. Flamingo pink.
Yeah! Flamingo right, pink. Yeah. I could, yeah. Honestly, let me get a pastel colored suit. I'd love that shit.
I feel like magenta is too strong for a suit jacket. Bubblegum is getting there, but not quite. But flamingo's like a soft
what the fuck?
Flirtation. It says I'm cheesy, but maybe I'm also in the 60s and wanting to sing jazz.
Oh man, you know what? Let me change mine. Let me get a full white suit.
Yeah, do you know how often you have to wash that?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
but just...
You just become discount Colonel Sanders.
And? Give me a white top hat, too. I don't give a shit. I love white suits.
Like, is your undershirt going to be a different color, or are you going full white?
Full white. Full white, baby.
No, man.
No, you have to have at least, like, a black undershirt or something white to give yourself contrast.
White as the day I was born, Zach. White as the day I was born.
That's more of a cream color, Jonah.
I'll show you a cream color, Kieran.
I'd rather
not. On that note, goodbye.
On that note, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up stream. All right. Well, thank you guys for joining me tonight. This has been a hoot, as always. And I'm looking forward to next week for our Civ 5 stream, for those that are going to be there for that. I am very interested for that. For instance, if you get a top hat, that gives very early cinema musical energy. Precisely. So if you want to stay, feel free to stay. If you want to go ahead and go. But thank you guys for joining me tonight. I will be back either way in a moment. John wants to greet people at the end of the last exclusively white suit. That's what I want. I want to be the person who greets at the end of their lives. I'm going to help them get over. If I could do that, honestly. Can we just get real for a moment, chat? The Grim Reaper gets such a bad rap. Like, yeah, it's scary, but you know, if I'm going over there to the other side, I feel like it would be very nice to have somebody accompany me there. I mean, I don't know. The skeleton in a hooded robe and wielding a scythe seems a bit ominous, but you know, it's nice to have the company. Anyway, that morbid bit aside, that's going to do for tonight. So thank you, everybody, so much for coming on out here tonight. This has always been a blast. I always love having the iceberg questions to spark discussions and whatnot. But in case peeps weren't already aware, we are going to be taking a break from Deep Rock Spawn streams next week, as in a couple days or so, Goldblade is going to be overhauling the spawn mod entirely, which means that all the profiles are going to get wiped. It's exciting because there's going to be a lot of new cool features. I'm very excited for. I can't spoil anything as per Goldblade's request, but let's just say I will tell you guys this. there is a lot more in terms of interactivity that you guys can do with the bugs. That's all I'm going to say. I'm interested to see how it's going to work given what Goldblade has shown us. So there might be an extra week or so where we kind of tinker around with it to figure out what's going on. Yeah, I just hope my Reaper is voiced by Christopher Lee. Same here, honestly. The Grim Reaper is scary to those who don't recognize him. The imagery was poor on purpose by the opposition, but the Grim Reaper is actually Jesus, but I digress. Either way, psychopomps like the Grim Reaper have been in the world long before Jesus. Yeah. Just, I guess it's just more of like a recent image thing, but still, you know, it's nice to have that company going to the other side. That's my two cents on that. What other announcements are there? So yeah, we'll be taking a break next week and we're going to be playing Civ 5 with the boys. I don't know who exactly is going to be showing up for that. I think so far we have Zach confirmed. Sounds like Guanji's going to be there. I think Joel expressed interest in possibly being there. So I'm going to reach out and see who wants to, who wants to join up for that. But yeah, it's going to be fun. It's going to be chill. I think we're all going to do like a team game versus AI or something like that. Or maybe we could all go up against each other. That might be fun too. But who knows? We'll see what happens when we get there. I'd like to just do a nice chill team versus AI sort of thing. But yeah, we'll figure it out when we get there. But that's what's going to be up for next week. But I have very exciting news for Sunday. Oh my God, we finally have the fucking PlayStation back. So, I'm so happy, you guys. I played Red Dead with Eden for the first time in over a month yesterday, and it was so nice to get back to it. But we are going to be returning to Dead Space on Sunday. And I think what we're going to be doing with Tears of the Kingdom, we're still kind of feeling out Eden's work schedule, but we really want to have, we're looking at possibly making it on Tuesday nights as part of, like, normally we have that night be our date night, but, you know, playing Tears of the Kingdom together on stream is, we're both really wanting to do that, but Eden's still kind of figuring out what the commute feels like to and from work, how busy she's going to be, that sort of thing. Press X to down. Oh boy, what's happening here? But yes, I am very excited to finally get back into playing the Dead Space remake. I'm going to have to replay a little bit of it in between now and then, because it has been, it's been well over a month now since I last replayed it. I still don't know when I should be at work. Yeah, so we're still kind of feeling that out. So we're going to give it maybe a week, maybe two. Eden also still needs to play a bit more to kind of get used to everything. You can have your own opinions on the matter until you find out for yourself. I mean, there's also probably like historical record to John through tales and legends and whatnot. But okay, anyway, we're not here to debate that. I'm here to wrap up. Anyway, like I should be. So tune in around the usual time for Sundays. We're finally bringing those back. It's been far too long, and I'm so sorry about that, but we're finally back to playing Dead Space. And once we complete that, we're going to have Tears of the Kingdom be on Sundays as well. So that's going to be a good time. Yeah, let's not go there with that. That's kind of we're pushing a touchy subject and topic there. So let's chill out with that. But anyway, that'll do for tonight. As always, I've blathered on long enough. Thank you, everybody, for coming on out here. Thank you for everybody who threw stuff at us. Always a pleasure to do this. And yeah, that'll do for tonight. I'm pretty wiped. I haven't been sleeping too well lately, so I'm going to probably start winding down and call it a relatively earlier night than I usually like to, but who knows? We'll see what happens. Stay safe, stay healthy. Don't forget to love each other and love your pets. And as always, I will hopefully see you in the next stream. Take care, everybody. Have a good night.